Monday, October 10th, 2016, the world is watching. Trump has climbed back from the edge of destruction with a devastating victory. 3-1, the planet is watching as the United States attempts to pull out of the New World Order and global government and reestablish self-determination. This is the Alex Jones Show, broadcasting worldwide.
I didn't think I'd say this, but I'm going to say it, and I hate to say it, but if I win, I am going to instruct my attorney general to get a special prosecutor to look into your situation, because there has never been so many lies, so much deception. There has never been anything like it, and we're going to have a special prosecutor. When I speak, I go out and speak, the people of this country are furious. In my opinion, the people that have been long-term workers at the FBI are furious. There has never been anything like this, where emails and you get a subpoena. You get a subpoena, and after getting the subpoena, you delete 33,000 emails. And then you acid wash them, or bleach them, as you would say, a very expensive process. So we're going to get a special prosecutor, and we're going to look into it, because you know what? People have been... their lives have been destroyed for doing one-fifth of what you've done. And it's a disgrace. And honestly, you ought to be ashamed of yourself.
You know, it is, it's just awfully good that someone with the temperament of Donald Trump is not in charge of the law in our country.
Because you'd be in jail.
Secretary Clinton.
Be in jail. Yes, that man needs to be president. Total leadership. Absolutely has her in the target sights. And now is pulling the trigger. This is an incredible time to be alive, and I am so glad to be here. We're going to play tons of the debate. If he would have done this in the first one, he'd be 20 points ahead, not just 10 points ahead in the real polls. They know there's a landslide coming. They know Bill Clinton's sex crimes are coming out, the rape settlements. They're desperate. They are going to bring out incredible hoaxes. They're going to hire women to say Trump raped them. Never a history of this in 40-plus years. Longer than that. I mean, the guy's 70. So he's been above 20, you know, for a long time. 50 years. Never. Women say he spoils the living daylights out of them. In the so-called dirty talk tape, he's trying to lavish the woman with gifts. In fact, that's what they say. Trump avalanches women with jewelry and everything else. And then if they're ever mean to him or treat him bad, he's gone like that. You treat Donald Trump bad, it's a well-known MO, he's gone. Gone. And I'm here to tell you, locker room talk, listen, once these criminals that sold us out to the communist Chinese and funded the radical jihadis and opened our borders and engaged in every crime you can imagine, like creating derivatives, getting rid of Glass-Steagall, starting all these illegal wars, putting more hardcore sanctions on than even Herbert Walker Bush did, and killing over 500,000 children. They admit that. That's the real crime here. And saying it's a good price to pay. Once they're in trouble for selling blood filled with AIDS and HIV, HIV that causes AIDS and hepatitis, I mean, the crimes go on and on. It makes the head spin. Once she ever got in trouble for that, then we can take Donald Trump to the woodshed for shooting his mouth off. You know, I've talked to people that know Donald Trump very well, not just Roger Stone, but other folks in Hollywood and famous actors. And yes, I've talked to a very famous model. I'm just going to stop right there. And they said, if anyone knew how straight-laced Donald Trump was, it would make their head spin. That's him like a little kid trying to act cool. The guy is so straight-laced. He eats like a gallon, half gallon of ice cream every night. He's like a little kid. Okay, I mean, he's very smart, but it's just, I'm saying stuff Trump probably doesn't even want out there. The point is that he's Mr. Good Boy, okay? And that's why he sounded like a 14-year-old. We'll be back. It's epic. Stay with us. Stop telling him to wear gloves. Stop telling him to sit there and take it. And I know he's been told that. And you saw Donald Trump last night. He tore the living hell out of Hillary. And he did it just right. That's why they tried to spin the whole thing and say he was looming behind her, standing by his chair, and then she would get in front, and then they would say, look, he's a bully. That's all over the news. This is how they take this huge victory, and try to turn into he's this bully of women. When Hillary Clinton represented a known pedophile who raped and put a 12-year-old girl in a coma for 5 days, when Hillary Clinton has been caught on two tapes laughing about it, saying she knew he was guilty, when she pushes partial birth abortion of eight-month-old babies, when she pushes funding jihadis and stays in the same hotel room with a woman who's a jihadi, whose mother is the top pusher of genital mutilation, and she funds jihadis worldwide, murdering Christians by the hundreds of thousands. She is an architect of Syria, an architect of the fall apart in Iraq and the destabilization. That's their plan. An architect of Libya. The plan is deindustrialization, dehumanization, take secular countries, overthrow it, depopulate them, put jihadis in charge of them. See, I'm not, quote, Islamophobic of some people that are not radical, extreme, orthodox Wahhabist. But I have to fight Islam now because it's run by Wahhabists. It's satanic. They chop up people and make prisoners eat them. They put five-year-old girls in sex slavery, and we're being invaded by it. This weekend, when I was shooting a video up on an overlook on 360 over the famous 360 bridge, there were a bunch of guys, and I could tell they were from Saudi Arabia, and they were all about six, seven of them running around, jabbering in Arabic, going, "Look, Alex Jones," and they would kind of try to get the camera shot and cut into what I was doing. And at a certain point, I said, "Why don't you just get the hell out of the country?" I was there with Zimmerman. So just get the hell out of here. If you don't like it, you don't think I don't know what you're doing? They all kind of backed off. It's like, yeah, I'm done playing games, okay? I'm done. Feel your hand. You're looking for trouble? You got it. Obama, Hillary, Bill Clinton, you're looking for trouble. You got it. You understand? You got it. I can only be pushed so far. Just got red hot, man. I just got angry. Ugh. Going back to that hilltop. Because it went on for like 20 minutes, them trying to interfere with the shot. Zimmerman was there. He saw it. I just finally turned around and looked at him, and I said, "If your damn country's so good, why don't you go the hell back to it, man? You want to come conquer me?" With all those people have is arrogance, and I'm tired of it, and I'm fed up. But I thought of how similar radical jihadis are and slimy, how they're just like liberals. They're all fake, and how they're intellectual and they're smart, and they just have this fake arrogance. I'm so sick of people that have arrogance but don't have anything behind it. They got big, giant, 14-foot-around cowboy hats, and they've never seen a cow. They're all hat and no cattle. And that's what this whole New World Order is about. Hillary Clinton, Bill Clinton. Go to drudgereport.com. He's linked to our story, top story. New WikiLeaks email, Clinton campaign insiders fear Bill's sex life could sink Hillary. Yeah, no kidding. Let me tell you what will sink Hillary is Donald Trump breaking the hoax, and he did it last night, breaking the matrix. Look at Bill Clinton right there, if you're a TV viewer. Radio listeners, you all saw him last night. I want to slow that down. I want to get the actual video. We have it in HD in there. It's all over the web. I want to slow that down to where it's basically, you know, a frame every second or so. I want to just slow it down into like a one-minute video of him just over like 3 seconds, just slowly to see the demon, the big intimidator, the guy that beats women, bites women, assaults women. Because he's got to have it. An animal. And that is the Trump campaign ad, is that monster and his enabler. He's not homosexual. Hillary isn't his beard for men. Hillary is his beard. Hillary's got pregnant with Lester Hubble. That's well known. She's there to cover for him, and she always has. And that's why she's the boss. Because he's the drug addict. He's the one that doesn't work. He's the one that's got to have up to 10 women a day on average. He's the one taking ecstasy and cocaine and methamphetamine for decades. He's the drug addict, and she can't stand him. That's why she didn't defend him. But let me tell you something. You look at that monster. As a country, we're going to put that back in the White House. Give me a break. All right, let me break down what happened last night from my view. We're going to open the phones up today. I really want to take a lot of your calls on the debate, how epic this is, but listen to me. I had family call me. I had people come up to me on the street this weekend. I got emails. I had crew people despondent, saying, oh my gosh, this locker room talk, it's over. 11 years old, take it out of context, it's a Bush nephew, whole thing's clearly a setup, and it's that's all you've got? I mean, I'm a pretty straightforward, righteous guy on average, but I talk about how I'm a sinner. Sometimes, just out of the blue, I'll say something really mean to a family member. Sometimes I'll catch myself saying something really nasty, just out of the blue, really vulgar. And that's why I say even people that are good-hearted aren't perfect. But, I mean, this is his crime? Talking about a super hot woman? And you can tell it's all edited. He goes, oh, and then I found out she was married. That was clearly all out of context. I've experienced people cutting my audio and moving it around. You can hear it. In fact, I want to take the raw audio that first aired, the Washington Post put out, and I want to show people on a graph. You can, because I hear it. I mean, I'm an audio editor. I've been doing this myself for 25 years. Not to distort, just to cut stuff out. I heard the points where it was being edited, and the background noise was different, different oscillations of the bus, different things happening. Part of that was recorded when the bus wasn't even moving. Then part of it's recorded when it is. You can tell he was baiting him in the whole time and then moving it around once they release it to make it sound like he was saying he was going after her. No, he learns she's married and then backs off of it. But Trump didn't even defend it. He knew the public wouldn't get that. He just said, okay, I apologize. Locker room talk. Let's move forward. Just like when he's on Howard Stern to pitch his hotels and things, because Howard Stern has a gigantic show. Especially back when he was going on it. I mean, it was reaching 30 million people a week sometimes. On the top of folks that go to casinos and go to hotels. And I'm not defending any of it. But imagine Stern's asking him all these questions. He does that when I come on. He does it to everybody. And Trump's like, yeah, sure, let's get back to this. Yeah, okay, maybe Iraq's okay. You know, 3 years after we're already in there. Before we had the Iraq war, he was on Fox, CNN, you name it. We've played the tapes saying it's a bad idea. We shouldn't do it. Once we were in there, he said, well, I'm not going to not back the troops. I thought it was a bad idea, but okay, now we can't just leave the place because it's going to fall apart like it happened. The guy's really smart, and he listens to top generals. So we've got Hillary's potty mouth and all the things she's been caught doing. Just get that effing dog out of my way, said Secret Service canine handler. Where is the GD flag? I want the GD effing flag up every morning at effing sunrise. Hillary to staff in Arkansas governor's mansion. These are all famous quotes. I've had a lot of these Secret Service on. Let me tell you something. I've talked to two separate Blackwater people. Because once I talked to one, I talked to another. I just brought it up. And he goes, yeah, no, I've done details for her when she was in the Middle East. And yeah, she would constantly flip out and cuss everybody out. And they'd bring a dog into her quarters to check, chase somebody planted a bomb. She'd go, what the F is that dog? Get that F in him. And blow up for like 15 minutes screaming. And you talk to somebody else, and I go, how did Hillary used to act? Oh, she'd blow up and scream and act crazy. Or she'd go into a trance and just sit there for like an hour while they were driving, just looking down, and she was a robot. I mean, I probably could get these guys on the air. I mean, they're so sick of her. People go, oh, Blackwater, that's the most evil organization in the world. Blackwater got blamed, and I was even guilty of some of this at the time, for every other mercenary group, including super cheap ones that hire like minimum wage people that aren't even soldiers, literally. Out of England is one of the worst groups. And then they got blamed for all other contractors. Kind of like Google becomes the name of search engines. You don't say search engine, you say Google. You say mercenaries, you say Blackwater. And I'm certainly not defending Prince and some of the stuff that went on. My point is just talking to the Blackwater people I've run into and others, they talk about, because that's who protected the diplomatic details, people like Secretary of State Clinton. She is a freaking monster. And it's well documented. So she's up there, how dare you, you're so despicable, you're so horrible, what you said about women. Oh my gosh, I can't believe children are hearing this. And the first question set it up, the black teacher, she goes, are we going to have appropriate things here tonight, or are you both going to be appropriate people? And Cooper goes, excellent point. What about your uncouthness? What about your badness to set it all up for Hillary? And notice Stone, happens from a top Democrat, said, when Hillary moves over, acting like she's going to shake hands, when Trump extends it, they're not going to shake hands. And notice, Hillary walks up to Trump. He doesn't extend his hand, so she doesn't go there because it's like that high school joke or that junior high joke or middle school joke where you extend your hand and then comb your hair with it and don't shake the person's hand as an act of disrespect. So Trump kept his hand back. She didn't extend hers. She came over. We need to get that video. to the very start. She came over wanting him to do it, but it didn't happen because it was a setup. So they went to plan two. First, he was going to ask Hillary, why didn't you shake his hand? Well, because of what he did to women. I'm a great woman and my daughter, blah, blah, blah. We're going to skip this break. Sorry, I forgot to tell you. So much is happening. So much is going on. So much is unfolding. This is a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful time to be alive. They are going to pull out all the stops against Trump. But I want to caution everybody. We go up in emotion. We go down in emotion. I go back to everybody so freaked out earlier in the week. This is the most important thing I'm going to say today. Out of a whole field of things we're going to cover and the clips we're going to play and the calls we're going to take. That you have to, and I don't mean my audience, but the general public, libertarians, conservatives, patriots, you have to remember when the mainstream media says all the Republicans are leaving Trump, Trump's collapsing, Trump's going to resign, Trump's going to give in, it's the end of Trump, they're running a giant perception hoax. Now, I know you know that, but people still, who are weak-minded, buy into it. You've got to explain to them, are you your own person? Or do you just go with which way you think the wind's blowing? Because the mainstream media doesn't control which way the wind blows unless you buy into the fraud. And look at it. Look at it. Take the lemons and turn into lemonade. The guy made some immature, kind of goofy, waspish, stuff. We all know, probably half the guys we talk to, you know, when you're hanging out, say similar stuff. And it's just kind of goofy. I just kind of ignore it and move on. I mean, I don't really tell people how I eat steaks. I just eat steaks. You know what I mean? So I don't really get into the whole how sausage is made or whatever. But a lot of guys do. And they tell stories. It's like sea stories or fish stories. It's hunting, you know, imaginary birds. What's that type of hunting everybody always tells kid that hadn't gone hunting, they take him out in the field or the woods. They say, here's a bag. And you run around and you catch the snipe. And then about 2 hours later, he realizes everybody's run off. And then you tell him, pull back up in the truck. And they say, hey, buddy, these type of birds don't exist. Or it's similar to that. But I'm not going to get caught in that anymore. All I'm saying is Hillary's an international war criminal involved in every crime, money laundering, funding jihadis, representing child molesters, protecting Bill Clinton's rape and abuse. It goes on and on. He is like a character out of a science fiction horror movie who's some grave digger or grave robber. He's like the big evil guy that, you know, grabs the kids out of the car that are kissing in the back seat in a horror movie and drags them off to, you know, chop them up inside some underground morgue. I mean, I would cast him as a top killer, ghoul, or somebody that aliens taken over. I mean, look at him. He is the most ghoulish, evil-looking person I've probably ever seen, except for Tim Kaine, who looks like a child molester. I'm not saying he's a child molester, but if I was going to cast someone in Hollywood as a creepy guy that goes around and tries to pick kids up, you know, with a creeper Astro van, white creeper van, that says free candy and puppies. That's who I would pick. I mean, these are manifestly creepy people. And then you look at Bill Clinton. He's got the whole background. He's got the whole MO. He's got it all. He's got it in spades, flying around on the Lolita Express, 20-plus trips. I kept saying 16. It's 20-plus trips, round trips to the pedophile island, flying out on the pedophile plane to the Middle East to meet with a top sheik who's in the news as reportedly having harems of boys and girls. I mean, it's well known in some of those Muslim countries, folks, that you're a good-looking woman and you land and you walk out of the mall, you're grabbed, you're thrown in the back of a car because the sultan, you know, some random sultan, there's hundreds of them per country, sometimes thousands of princes, like in Saudi Arabia, you're gone and you don't ever get seen again. And listen, maybe your family has some money and finds out what's going on and tries to go to the U.S. Embassy. They say, listen, your daughter's gone. She's in a slave pit, okay? That's who Hillary gets hundreds of millions of dollars from. That's who these people are. And so, as I told you, there's a dossier out, and it's going to be coming out today in the next few days, where they have Jane Doe's unannounced people and witnesses that are called Jane Doe's and Tiffany Doe's claiming 22 years ago, Trump, who barely even knew Epstein, raped a teenager. All of it Jane Doe, Tiffany Doe, this Doe, that Doe. The person that delivered the teenager is the witness in secret, given immunity. And it's a judge appointed by Obama in 2011 in the district Hillary Clinton was a U.S. senator. I mean, this is unbelievable. So listen, Trump did the right thing. He came out of the gates. He tore her apart. He told it like it was. The media was never going to leave him alone. They're never going to stop cheating. They're never going to be sweet to him if he just plays along. That's all a hoax. And any advisors telling Trump that are wrong. Trump, you exploded in the polls. Frank Luntz and others said he's not seen, basically in his modern political career, someone's numbers spike with focus groups like they did. You went straight up like a Saturn rocket, okay? Because everyone hates Hillary. The Democrats hate Hillary. They're all scared of her. They're tired of her. They know how creepy she is. They know how evil she is. They know she's falling down every 20, 30 minutes. And look at the email on drudgereport.com. Very top story. New WikiLeaks email, Clinton campaign insiders fear Bill Clinton's sex life could sink Hillary. They should shut the hell up about this, Podesta told them. That's in the new WikiLeaks email dump released today, reveals that some Hillary campaign insiders are petrified that Bill Clinton's sordid sexual past could severely damage Hillary's chances. Yes, that's why they've cooked it all up to throw it on Trump. Oh, this woman was so beautiful. I wanted to take her and buy her furniture. I wanted to date her. Oh, my gosh, she's so beautiful. Well, that's horrible. Meanwhile, yes, I'm going to meet with the Sultan on the pedophile plate, to get $2 million. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, Hillary represents pedophiles. It's just, it's all, these are like demons. And then she's giggling and snickering about it. The revelation is a particular note because it dovetails with Donald Trump holding a press conference yesterday before the debate with three of Bill Clinton's sexual abuse victims and others he jumped on. The email, which is marked confidential, was sent to the Clinton campaign chairman John Podesta by prominent left-wing journalist Brent Bodowski. It includes details of his exchange with someone in the media who told him that there are people close to Clinton's who say William Jefferson Clinton's sex life could be damaging to her. Folks, he jumps on women in front of Democrats in ballrooms. He's a total maniac. Total maniac. He makes Casanova or Charlie Sheen or the famous guy that played Don Juan. No, who's the famous guy that played, who was the biggest womanizer ever, they said, back in the 30s and 40s in Hollywood. No, Errol Flynn. Those are women that wanted it, though, because, you know, it's Errol Flynn. No, not with Bill Clinton, man. He will attack you in a second. So it goes on from there. Then he's told to basically shut up about it and not talk about it. So here they are scrabbling around trying to cover it up. They're like, just shut up about it. Just don't talk about it. So Bill Clinton's on a big power trip. I love the new Ben Garrison cartoon. It's on the bottom right-hand corner of Infowars.com. The debate souvenir is Hillary Clinton 2017 for prison. And don't you love how the meme that you, the listeners, created? Sure, we created the first image. We put the idea out. We promulgated Hillary for prison 2016. But now as the year gets long on the tooth, just 3 months left, a little less than 3 months, you pushed lock her up. You pushed put her in prison. You pushed she was a criminal because she is. And the shoe fits. And now it's out there. And all she can do now is with Homeland Security steal the election. If we don't buy the media hoax that he's dropping out, we've seen the last year three times where they all say he's dropping out. There's an intervention. It's over. The whole party turned against him. And then the who's who of Republican neocons who all need to be unelected, who were against him before and said you couldn't vote for him and said they'd ignore you at the convention in Cleveland. All of that got ignored. You figured it out. Not once, but twice. Now, the third time, they come out with 28 days out, and they're telling you it's all over because he had some racy talk. Oh, my gosh. And he went on Howard Stern when he knew he was on there and had racy talk. Yes, he's never hidden that he sometimes has racy talk when talking to other guys. I don't want to say it's a cliche of New Yorkers, but you hear a lot of it down here in Texas. You hear some of it in California. The deep South, you don't hear a lot of talk like that. Men don't generally do that. I'm not knocking New Yorkers. I love them. But I'll be in New York at a press deal or whatever at dinner, and people are like, look at her. Boy, I'd like to get a piece of that. Oh, I'd do anything for her. I mean, that's kind of what goes on. It's kind of funny. Big deal. So, defending pedophiles you know are guilty, hanging out with sultans that are reportedly pedophiles, flying around on pedophile planes, settling rape cases. Oh, that's no big deal. On and on and on, selling us out to jihadis that are running around murdering women in mass. I'm going to play a bunch of clips, go through it all, and chart the path to victory straight ahead, ladies and gentlemen. But don't let the media hoax you. Don't let them mind control you. Donald Trump was channeling the InfoWar last night. Obviously, we had the right side feed for everybody that didn't want to hear my commentary overlying Hillary, but they were three against one. So I said, listen, it's two against three. The cavalry's here on that broadcast. Some people wanted to hear me screaming over them. One thing we should do is fade her down a little bit when I am talking over her, because it is kind of grating. That's not the crew's fault. I should have directed them to do that. But I want to just say something before I get into all the big news here in these clips. The crew, when they were hosting, and then when they were hosting after I left at 10 o'clock or so, they did another hour and a half, was the best radio / TV I've ever seen on politics. I mean, you've got all these other pundits following talking points from the parties and groups and media combines, many of them getting direct emails from Hillary on what to say, what to do. Comedians, movie stars, anchors, it's all come out in WikiLeaks. So good job, WikiLeaks, starting to put some good meat out. I was wrong to go off half-cocked. I'm not in the position Assange is in. I get it. I want to win. I'm tired of these people. He's a smart guy. I genuinely apologize. But he did, I mean, I have the excuse. I am sorry. But I have the excuse that you kept saying it was coming out. You kept saying it would get her indicted. And then you implied it was going to be that day. So I'm up at 4 in the morning, and I'm watching, you know, these boring WikiLeaks reporters. I'm sorry. I got angry, but you have redeemed yourself. Thank you, WikiLeaks. More information. We need more. This woman's dangerous. She wants to launch war with Russia. She said she wants to. These people are out of control, and that's why I'm getting such high-level leaks. Because Democrats close to Hillary now realize she's mentally ill, she's vicious, she's hateful, she's getting worse, and they are just telling me there's a feeling of doom. A feeling of being in Hitler's bunker was one quote. And we don't know what to do because this is our job. It's everybody we know. It's like we're in the mafia. And there's just a feeling of doom. And I feel it too, just watching it. I mean, that's why I can't sleep with 28 days out. But the crew did an absolutely amazing job. And Trump hit her with everything. I mean, I've said in videos I posted Saturday, I said, he's got to come out and say, how dare you? You're despicable covering up for the rape of a 12-year-old that you represented in bills settling sexual assault cases. How dare you say my locker room talk, word for word, my locker room talk is a big deal when you've done all these horrible things. And Trump came out and did exactly that. And not because he got it from me, but because he gets it and he understands. And I'm not going to sit there on Friday when everybody's panicking, abandon ship, we're all dead, it's over. Oh, my God, the mainstream media said it's over. His wife's going to leave him. Pence is going to leave him. It's over. Ladies and gentlemen, they've discovered secret Howard Stern tapes. Oh, we've got him now. It's live on the radio. Stuff he said 15 years ago, 20 years ago. When you go on Stern, it's a giant audience. People say, why'd you go on that potty mouth show? Because, I'm not saying I'm Christ, but, you know, Christ went in to where the prostitutes were, the money changers, the tax collectors, because he wasn't trying to get the Pharisees. He was trying to get the general public. I've gone on Stern and his sub-networks many times because we get big listeners from it. All the time I see people on the street, I never knew about any of this until I heard you on Stern. I heard you on Stern. I woke up. I woke my friends up. It changed my whole life. I got off Prozac, blah, blah, blah. I probably had 500 people come up to me and say they learned about the show from Howard Stern. Probably more. It's like almost every time I go out in public, somebody comes over about Howard Stern. It's a big show. He goes on there and you have to sit there where Stern goes, so when'd you first have sex? So when'd you do this? So when'd you do that? I'm a real person. I'm not hiding. I'm like 12 years old. Oh, you felt you were abused? No, she was 16. I loved it. And it's not because I'm a potty mouth. That's the tell-all show. Sure, I'll go on there. But I said after 5 minutes of that, I said, now let's move on to fluoride in the water. Let's move on to how the fish are becoming sterile, while the sperm's becoming sterile. He's laughing the whole time. But I'm waking people up, millions of them. And I was told later, higher up said, dude, and Stern rarely, as people tell him, don't have folks on. I was told, people said, man, we had the highest ratings. He said it the next week. He said we had the highest listenership and the highest positive response to Alex of any guest we've ever had, 86% positive. They had a poll. They said, I've never seen anything like it. Did you ever be back on Stern himself? No. They put me on their sub channels, and then they said, well, yeah, we've been gotten crackdowns on that. Can't have you on anymore. That's fine. The point is, the enemy didn't want me on there because I was having a big effect. Other big shows get bucked when I come on. They have to put their jobs on the line to have me on. George Norrie's done that. He's got a lot of courage. And when I'm on there, executives are watching, looking for one mistake to burn him. There's some good people there, too, but there's a takeover in the media. There's a takeover in talk radio happening. There's a takeover at Fox. I told you, I know all the inside baseball. I can't say a lot of it here on air. I know the Savage stuff. I know the Clear Channel stuff. I know the Cumulus stuff. Basically, I know it all, okay? And it's bad, okay? We run our own operation here. That's what they cannot stand. GCN's just our satellite provider. God bless them. They're great folks. But it's mom and pop. And I don't want to get into myself anymore, but we're all interconnected. You're interconnected. And I have to let you, the audience, know what we're going through, what we're dealing with. If something horrible comes out and Trump comes out and agrees he did it, I will then weigh it. But I'm never a lesser of two evils person, but with Hillary, there's not even the same universe. I mean, she is an abject, psychopathic demon from hell that as soon as she gets into power is going to try to destroy the planet. I'm sure of that. And people around her say she's so dark now and so evil and so possessed that they are having nightmares. They're freaking out. Folks, let me just tell you something. And if the media wants to go with this, that's fine. There are dozens of videos and photos of Obama having flies land on him indoors at all times of year, and he'll be next to 100 people and no one has flies on him. Hillary reportedly, I mean, I was told people around her that they think she's demon-possessed, okay? I'm just going to go ahead and say it, okay? They said they're scared. That's why when I see her when kids are by her, I actually get scared myself for the child. I mean, you that big rubber face and that... I mean, this woman is dangerous, ladies and gentlemen. I'm telling you. She is a demon. This is biblical. She's going to launch a nuclear war. The Russians are scared of her. By the way, when people are scared of you and they got nuclear weapons, you have a big war. When you're scared, you fight. When you're a man. You don't crawl in a hole and stick your butt out the other end so the wolf can eat it. You fight. And I'm going to tell the Democrats something. And all the trendies, all the rest of you, you've lived on the guts of your ancestors. You've lived off what was built before. You don't appreciate anything. You're pseudo-intellectuals that think you know everything. I've been around you. You are despicably sad and pathetic people. I'm going to consider and kiss your ass. If you want to redeem yourself, then admit Donald Trump's right. Admit he's a lion with a bunch of jackals attacking him and hyenas. Stand up for what's right. Admit the entire power structure you claim you're not part of is against him. And then ask yourself why you want to be part of this delusion club, the delusionites, the delusionals, where you think you're a winner and you think everything's okay because you said so. You're living in your own world. I know I'm right. And this is a fight against the hoax machine. It's a fight against the mainstream media. It's a fight against globalism. It's a fight against all the corruption we've seen. The Republican Party establishment, the Bushes, the mass graves, the dead children, the sanctions, the wars. I mean, Trump last night was so genuine. You could tell he got down to real Trump last night when she's like, you're with the Russians. He goes, I don't even know the Russians. I have nothing to do with the Russians. But why would we want to have a war with them? They're not doing anything to us. We need to link up and defeat radical Islam with them. And she's the one launching the modern jihad. She knows full well. Here he is trying to stop World War III. Hillary and her people are trying to start a war with Russia. They admit they are. They're trying to overthrow it internally. The Soros' group. It's on record. And here's this guy going, yeah. Yeah, okay, yeah, I don't want to have war with Russia. Does that mean I work for him? What's your problem? You're a despicable person. She sleeps in the same room with that creepy weirdo woman, Uma Abedin, whose mother wears a hood over her head and writes top articles in the world promoting cutting women's genitals off? What the hell? That woman, number one, is ugly and evil. But imagine if you're like, oh, what does your mom do? Oh, she's a top genital mutilation pusher. I'd be like, whoa, get the hell away from me. Again, but Hillary's into like creepy, weird, sick stuff, man. Just disgusting with flies all over, big fat, stinking dick. Imagine how bad she smells, man. I'm told her and Obama just stink, 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 stink. You can't wash that evil off, man. I'm told there's a rotten smell around Hillary. I'm not kidding. People say, they say, folks, I've been told this by high up folks. They say, listen, Obama and Hillary both smell like sulfur. I never said this because the media go crazy with it, but I've talked to people that are in protective details. I mean, they're scared of her. And they say, listen, she's a freaking demon and she stinks and so does Obama. And I go, like what? Sulfur. They smell like hell. I mean, I hate to go down this road, folks, but I'm telling you, we're dealing with demons here. All right? Look at what they do. They go out of their way to do evil things. They keep babies alive and sell their body parts. They involve themselves in every form of wickedness you can imagine. And it's not like flies are landing on them a few times. I mean, if I'm out in the woods doing coverage, sometimes a fly will land. We're talking about in the middle of events, in the middle of the White House, in the middle of luncheons in Germany. No one else has flies on them, and there's just flies landing all over them. Okay, I'm going to stop there. I'm going to get these clips because these are epic clips. I need to get to them. There is so much unfolding. We're going to get a whole bunch of clips here in just a moment, but we do have Trump on Russia right now, so let's start with some of the clips. Since I mentioned that one, let's just start there.
I don't know, Putin. I think it would be great if we got along with Russia because we could fight ISIS together as an example, but I don't know, Putin. But I notice anytime anything wrong happens, they like to say, the Russians, the Russians. She doesn't know if it's the Russians doing the hacking. Maybe there is no hacking. But they always blame Russia. And the reason they blame Russia is because they think they're trying to tarnish me with Russia. I know nothing about Russia. I know about Russia, but I know nothing about the inner workings of Russia. I don't deal there. I have no businesses there. I have no loans from Russia. I don't know, Putin. I think it would be great if we got along with Russia.
There you go. Russia has 2.5 military bases. By that, they have one place they're able to fuel with ships, but it's not a base. So I see 2.5, because you can argue three or two. I went and looked into it. There's 2.5. The U.S. has 200-plus permanent bases, several hundred other sub-bases, and over 700, they still call them coaling stations, but it's where they get fuel and supply. We're over 1,000 bases at that point. Russia is not expansionist. Sorry. You know who is? China. Because they've been given the deal worldwide on basically all economic activity. Panama Canal, all the deep water ports, 97% of rare earth minerals. You don't think we couldn't be getting those? They've been given them. It's a global deal. It's admitted. They're allowed to have tariffs on us and higher corporate tax to make sure. I mean, lower corporate tax to keep ours high. To screw us. This is globalism. This is their deal. This is economic warfare by the corporate elite. Trump wants to end that. And you fools, and I'm not talking to our audience, but the people that make jokes, you know you've bet on pure evil. You know that you're wrong. Now, I'm going to get to some more of these clips. In fact, I want to go back to the first one because I've got like 15 of them. They're so amazing. Then we'll open the phones up and take your phone calls. Trump threatens to prosecute Clinton, so she's going to be in jail. Trump steamrolls Bill Clinton's past behavior with women, CNN caught coaching undercover voter panel. We've got so much coming up. But before I do that, we need to refuel this operation. You heard me skip a break earlier. That's expensive, but I'm just so on fire. We're going to end the Hillary for prison shirts in 28 days. Everybody else can still make them or whatever, but these are the originals. They're $19.95. We need to make, you know, the $15 off this to fund this operation. The reporters, the crew we had there covering it. This is very expensive, even though we run this from Texas. I couldn't do this if I was in New York or L.A. I mean, we'd be a third of the size. But by God's blessing, we ended up here. This is where I'm from, and we're able to do it. It's all worked organically. But we need to make some serious money around here to be able to fund these operations. We need to get a lot of money in here. So everybody, you already got a shirt, get another one. This is a war. You know it. You know we're at the tip of the spear. You know we are the national talking point memo against the New World Order along with Drudge. It's Drudge and InfoWars are the tip of the spear. Everybody else is right behind us. And believe me, I want them to get bigger than us, man. I don't like being the main target. We have another limited edition, Don't Tread on Me, with a Gadsden snake wrapped around Hillary. On the back, it says Lock Her Up. That's a limited edition. We're only doing this run of them. They're almost sold out, by the way. We've got the DNA Force, 23% off. Amazing. With the BioQQ, the BioPQQ, the CoQ10, all of it. The ultimate formula. Amazing discount right now. We also have our new probiotic, Biome Defense. We have 25 million live culture bottle. That is half the price of the one that's 50 million per pill. And this comes with a cold pack with it. This is the highest quality. There are competing nutraceuticals sold by doctors. They're not prescriptions, but doctors sell them that are $100, $150. There are some brands that aren't even as good at Whole Foods for $80, $90, $100. So we have this for, what, $40 and for $60-something dollars. Very expensive for us to produce. And the profit we make funds this operation. InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139. And I'm going to tell you something else. Our radio crew, our TV crew, our writers, our reporters, our backup people that run this operation, they've been working on salary 18 hours a day. And I say, volunteer if you want. I'm going to work 18 hours a day, 6-7 days a week until this is over. And you know what? I come up here sometimes at like 3 o'clock on a Saturday, and people are already here fighting and working without me. And they don't even want the money. But a lot of them aren't paid that much because we don't have that big a budget. I want to give them a big bonus. I know a lot of you want a bonus, too. This economy's in trouble, but you're funding, fighting back to get our republic. Believe me, he cuts taxes by 50% like he's about to do. Economy's going to explode. More receipts are going to come in. They're going to make more money, too. He does some simple things. Boom time's coming. Boom time. We need to get the ball across the goal line. InfoWarsLife.com, InfoWarsStore.com, or call toll-free 888-253-3139. We have BioTrue Selenium. I was getting really tired of being on air 5 hours last night. I didn't pop a brain force. They work great, but it keeps me up at night. I popped a BioTrue Selenium, and an hour later was just incredible energy. Selenium is electrochemical. It's one of the key things in the body. You die without it. It's one of the biggest game changers out there. We have the purest form from mustard seed, totally organic, over the top. It will knock you into the next level. I mean, it's incredible. Get that to InfoWarsLife.com. We'll be back. We're back. You know, I had a former national delegate of the Democrats on who in 96 was at the DNC in Illinois in Chicago. He was the fellow that took over the Tim Kaine event and did the best job screaming Bill Clinton's a rapist and wearing the shirt. And he described Hillary on the internal video screens to the people screaming F you and go to hell and all this stuff. I mean, she does this reportedly constantly. She's totally psychotic. I was just told something by the IT folks. We have a new upgraded digital phone system. It tells us how many calls we get and how many busy signals. And obviously, it's folks trying back over and over again. 23,000 calls last night. When we opened the phones up at like 10 o'clock at night central. CJ, tell us about this.
So basically, the new system is able to answer calls, and instead of giving somebody a busy tone and putting them on hold, they get a busy tone automatically and don't clog up our phone system. So although we were only able to take a couple dozen calls, we got 23,000. I think it was roughly 14,000 an hour.
And by the way, they were the best callers I ever heard. Daytime callers said to be half asleep or, you know, a lot of times out of work or, you know, taking the day off.
Folks work and have nights off.
Yeah, yeah. Or they're drinking beer or whatever. But and we have some great callers during the day, but we always get better ones at night. And that's why I really should just say first-time callers and get folks on who aren't just waiting till the second I say the number and call in, because the callers were so amazing last night. I mean, I'm telling you, I was so proud when I left here after doing 6 hours at 10:30, and I was driving home, and I just sat there in the parking lot at my house because my kids were already asleep for an hour listening to you guys, and it was just so seamless, so on target, so smart, so original, so on target. I love you guys. I love this crew. I love our reporters. I didn't usually talk like this. We've had some decent crews, but this is the crew. I love you. You understand that?
Yes, we can feel the love.
Oh, man, this is awesome. I mean, we're making history. We're doing the right thing. I'm so blessed that God put me in this position and that I'm not evil like the Clintons. I feel sorry for them, folks. They are so evil. It is such an honor to be fighting these people. I am so blessed. I just, it's amazing to me. It really is amazing that we've come this far. God's promise is so incredible. And I'm so thankful for all of you. Donald Trump has a good heart. It's so evident when he could just say he hates Russia and they'd put him in office. But he's like, I don't want to attack people that didn't do stuff to us. Russia does one thing, he'll go after them. The globalists are starting wars. They're evil. They're putting radical Islamics in to kill Christians and others. They're bad people. They're demonic. The devil in the Bible is known as the Lord of the Flies. Okay, I've got all these clips, and I just have been so excited this hour. I haven't gotten to a lot of them. Let's end this hour with the way I started it, and then we're going to come back and play clip after clip, give the phone number out, take your phone calls. But this was an epic moment, and folks, they're going to show up with women on TV, and it'll be so obvious they'll even work for the Clintons or something. It's like this judge, you know, put in by Obama, openly supported by the Clintons in Clinton's district in New York, and then now he's letting people with Jane Doe's say that he raped her 22 years ago. I mean, it's going to get worse than that, folks. It's going to get worse than that because these are evil people and they have to accuse him of what they've done. They know Trump was getting ready to expose the Epstein stuff. They know that was the battle plan. And Stone told him a year ago, do it now because they're going to cook it up on you, even though you've only been to one of his parties during the day and were there 30 minutes. He's talked about this a year ago. You've got to do this, Donald. He said, oh, they won't do that. Yes, they are. He just can't believe they're doing this. But now he's taking the gloves off because he has to. So get ready, folks. They may kill him, too. And how are you going to feel when you've been talking bad about Donald Trump when he's in so much danger? So when we come back, I've got like 15 clips. We're going to play them all. We're going to talk about them. We're going to break it down. But now is the time to pray for Donald Trump. Now is the time to donate. Now is the time to spread the word. But more important than donating, talk to your friends and family. If you're in one of these 10 battleground states, Pennsylvania, Ohio, Florida, Colorado, places like that, because they're not going to try to steal them in states where it's obvious, but they're going to engage in election fraud. We have to let everybody know Donald Trump's going to win by a landslide. Look for the steal. Stay with us. We'll be back. When you experience providence in your life, and you have a dream that really upsets you and is a waking dream, those special dreams. And then a month later, what you saw in the dream happens exactly as you were in the dream. You know there's a lot going on in this universe, don't you? We've all had those type of events. But I look at my life and all the things that happened to me, the good, the bad, the ugly, it was all building what I've done for 20 plus years on the air. All of it building towards the time we're in. All the skills, all the background, all of it clicking right when it was needed in God's plan. It's so humbling to be associated with all you, the listeners, and to be in this fight. It brings tears of joy to my eyes. And I'm somebody that didn't even used to cry at my grandparents' funerals. And now the energy level is so high. It's amazing. I think they're going to try to kill Trump, or they're going to have an assassination attempt on Hillary in the next week or two. All hell's going to break loose. Get ready. If she gets in, she's going to launch a war with Russia for sure. She is demonic. And everybody can feel it, including Democrats that are around her. And if anybody's got self-preservation instincts in them, if you've got any spirit left in you, folks, you've got to know Hillary Clinton and the Bush-Clinton crime machine must be stopped. And that's why I've told everybody, the gloves are off, brass knuckles are on. I know that all that matters is I throw myself every ounce of energy, every ounce of my will, all my blood, all my treasure, my family, everything, I put it all on the line. And I ask God to carry us the rest of the way. Everything I am, everything I'll ever be. We have to set our wills against these people. That's what God wants you to do, is to set your will against them and never surrender, never give up, never back down. I look at the public. They're starting to wake up, but they just, do you know the media lies? You know they twist. You know they create these petty events. They think you're small and stupid. And then still people somewhat buy into it. Not as much, but now if they do everything they can and do it just right, they're able to still kind of hoax a little bit. And then Trump, only when he's desperate, does the right thing and goes into the fray. We have to go like one of the most famous samurais. I quote this all the time. You pull it up, The Way of the Samurai's Desperateness. Print me off that, please. And The Arena. I want to read those. I should hang them on the wall. And it doesn't mean desperate like you're afraid. A coward thinks desperateness is like hiding and pissing on yourself. Desperateness is just completely turning loose. And that might mean total precision. That might mean out of control berserking. It just means getting in your center and just saying, I'm not thinking about it. I'm doing it. I'm not thinking about, I'm going to kick your ass. I'm going to beat your brains out. It's happening now. We're going to run over evil. And there's going to be other fights. But I'm telling you, these churches have been run by the globalists for a long time. They've taught you to stand down. They've taught you it's the end of the world. It might be. The point is, God's not going to recognize you if you don't stand up against evil now and hide out in these demonic churches. I can't go in these big churches. I'm a sensitive person. And I got the willies, everybody does, in the Roman Colosseum. I got the willies in the Vatican. I get worse willies in these big mainline churches than I got in the Colosseum at Rome. That's because most of these big preachers you see are globalist agents, and they hold a satanic office. It's one thing to be evil, but when you pose as a man of Christ and you aren't, it's the most demonic thing there is. Donald Trump never claims to be perfect, never claims. Are you Christian? He's like, yes, yes, I like God. But it's private with him. And then he's ashamed of things he does, so he doesn't want to say it. I see all of it. Compared to people that talk about how good they are all day and they're screwing kids at night. Let me tell you, a lot of these big preachers in your town, they're raping kids at night and they're in satanic covens. You need to know that. These big mega churches are Satan, are devil-worshipping pits. We'll be back. All right, I'm going to discipline myself now and get to all these clips, then your phone calls. Steve Pachinik wants to pop in. He always has important things to say. I don't know his view on the debate last night. I'll suspect this is, he's going to say, devastating victory, and what we should see constantly from Trump. Trump was misadvised, and I'm not going to attack people that advised him. I know who did it. Through back channels that Hillary wasn't going to attack him and play nice. And because he wanted to honor members of his family, Trump was nice in the first debate, and it was a giant miscalculation. Gloves are off. Brass knuckles are on. He knows he's been betrayed. He knows they're coming for him. He tried to not go in the gutter. He is going to absolutely battle axe them now. And we have to, too. That's why we started the Hillary for Prison, Lock Her Up movement. It's why we're doing the whole rape movement and why people have them under siege. There were Bill Clinton is a rapist, wanted Bill Clinton rapist signs all over the event. I'm going to have a bunch of PDFs made by my crew and put it on a Bill Clinton rape page on InfoWars. You can download our PDFs we're making using the epic, iconic image of him threateningly looking at the rape victims sitting to him, near him in the audience. There's one thing to have him with the image Stone made, which is fine, Bill Clinton smiling. No, we're going to have him when he has his rapist, you know, eyes bulging out. In fact, can we put him big behind me? From Drudge Report and InfoWars. Can we blow this up and put it behind me? Because that's what I want. That's the iconic image. That's what he did. We're slowing it down right now. We have some other angles, too, of him and Hillary freaking out during it and Hillary's response. We're going to put them side by side. This image tells 10 million words. So that's all coming up. But I was talking about desperateness, not in the way people think of desperateness, like cowardly desperateness, but the desperateness of a woman picking up a 2,000-pound car off her baby. It's been seen by police, firefighters, you name it. It's been documented. It's been caught on tape. We all have a governor. We suppress it. In times like these, get rid of the governor. Control yourself, but focus those tidal energies God gave you. Lord Khashoggi said The way of the samurai is desperateness. 10 men or more cannot kill such a man. Common sense will not accomplish great things. Simply becoming insane and desperate is the way of the samurai. If one uses discrimination, he will fall behind. One needs neither loyalty nor devotion, but simply to become desperate in the way. Loyalty and devotion are of themselves within desperation. I'm a loyal person. I'm a real person. I'm desperate. The enemy knows it. Why she calls me Dark Art, because I'm the opposite. I'm so loving, she knows I have no fear of her. Because I am loving. I am good. And I know evil when I see it. And I know Hillary is desperate and afraid in her own way. But she's so into herself, her desperateness doesn't give her power. Desperateness to yourself is weakness. Desperateness to defend the weak is chivalry. But you don't know that, do you? You claim you have the moral high ground all day and you love everyone so much when you're horrible pig people that steal furniture and plates from the White House and who think you're God. You're not. You're not humble. And the devil's sticking a big fat apple in your mouth right now and firing up that furnace. And when God gives the word, you're going to get slid right in there, face first. So enjoy. It's your party. You set it up. It's your tree. You're sitting in it. Enjoy. Eternity's big, and it's endless. It's filled with people like you who want to be together. That's all hell is, people like you want to be together. Okay. Let's go ahead and start with the clips. Let's begin at the beginning. Trump threatens to prosecute Clinton, and at the end says, you need to be in jail. This is beyond historical because it's so true. It's devastating. It's what everybody already knows. And he's just signaling the truth for everyone, and they can't stop the signal. It's amazing. Here it is.
I didn't think I'd say this, but I'm going to say it, and I hate to say it. But if I win, I am going to instruct my attorney general to get a special prosecutor to look into your situation, because there has never been so many lies, so much deception. There has never been anything like it. And we're going to have a special prosecutor.
Look at their arrogance.
When I speak, I go out and speak. The people of this country are furious. In my opinion, the people that have been long-term workers at the FBI are furious. There has never been anything like this where emails and you get a subpoena. You get a subpoena, and after getting the subpoena, you delete 33,000 emails.
Break them with hammers.
And then you acid wash them, or bleach them, as you would say, a very expensive process. So we're going to get a special prosecutor, and we're going to look into it, because you know what? People have been, their lives have been destroyed for doing one-fifth of what you've done, and it's a disgrace. And honestly, you ought to be ashamed of yourself.
You know, it is, it's just awfully good that someone with the temperament of Donald Trump is not in charge of the law in our country.
Yeah. Oh, yo, you need to be in charge because you've got such a great temperament. Now we have Trump getting into Bill Clinton's past behavior when Hillary has the nerve to bring up to him that he had some locker room talk. That's obviously highly edited as well. This is incredible. So we'll play that clip.
Jeff from Ohio asks on Facebook, Trump says the campaign has changed him. When did that happen? So, Mr. Trump, let me add to that. When you walked off that bus at age 59, were you a different man, or did that behavior continue until just recently? And you have 2 minutes for this.
As I told you, that was locker room talk. I'm not proud of it. I am a person who has great respect for people, for my family, for the people of this country, and certainly I'm not proud of it, but that was something that happened. If you look at Bill Clinton, far worse, mine are words, and his was action. His was what he's done to women. There's never been anybody in the history of politics in this nation that's been so abusive to women. So you can say any way you want to say it, but Bill Clinton was abusive to women. Hillary Clinton attacked those same women. And attack them viciously. Four of them here tonight. One of the women, who is a wonderful woman, at 12 years old, was raped at 12. Her client, she represented, got him off, and she's seen laughing on two separate occasions, laughing at the girl who was raped. Kathy Shelton, that young woman, is here with us tonight. So don't tell me about words.
Put her in a coma.
Absolutely, I apologize for those words.
I have daughters. It makes me
but
sick.
It is things that people say. But what President Clinton did, he was impeached. He lost his license to practice law. He had to pay an $850,000 fine to one of the women, Paula Jones, who's also here tonight. And I will tell you that when Hillary brings up a point like that, and she talks about words that I said 11 years ago, I think it's disgraceful, and I think she should be ashamed of herself, if you want to know the truth.
And then he goes on. There's another extra little giblet, but this is powerful. And he can get even more serious now. But notice, I was freaking out 5 minutes into it. He was letting Hillary attack. It was staged up with Cooper. First stage question about morals. He wasn't doing anything. He was apologizing, but he let him just keep attacking. They did three rounds of attacks, and I was just screaming, attack, attack, attack. And I knew I was right about Trump. I know he's not a shill. And I was like, how can my instinct, my gut be wrong? We're going to skip this break coming up. I got so upset, and then boom, he did it just right. Which, again, I was questioning him. I need to learn that I don't know everything. All of us do. That if my gut tells me he's God's with him, and my gut tells me I need to be with Trump, that he's going to do the right thing. My gut tells me, folks, if my gut ever tells me to turn against Trump, I'll turn against him. My gut's never wrong. Your gut's not wrong either, folks. Just go with it. But God gave it to you. Your brain communicates with you when you're not listening. The subconscious has the nerves right to your guts. And that's the bigger part of your brain that's 100, 200 times more powerful. And it knows. That's where your soul's at, too. Donald's great escape. Trump keeps his campaign alive with barnstorming comeback after confronting Hillary with four of Clinton's sex victims, and she fails to nail him over sleazy tape scandal. Sleazy. Talk about wanting to buy a woman a bunch of furniture. It's all edited. And he goes, oh, and then she was married. You can tell that was early on why he couldn't go out with her. It's clearly edited. We need to take that waveform, the original, and show folks, because I know I can hear it. How the background noise goes up and down. See, if you're in a bus and it's not edited, it's just going to be one continual deal. But I'm not going to get obsessed with that. There's just so much happening right now. This is so huge. Let's go to another clip here. Let's go ahead and play, because this is important. Let's go ahead and play. I've got so many of these clips. I don't know where to go here. Let's go. Clinton and moderators gang up on Trump. He calls them out. And then we have a Trump campaign video they put out pointing this out. But let's go ahead and play Clinton and the moderators.
Harper Witt.
Look, let me explain how this works. They got Cooper and Rat teamed up on him. I'm helping Donald, okay?
I'd like to know. Why aren't you?
You tune into other stuff and just got the feed. But they're 3-1. It's 2-3 now.
Tim Karpowitz has a question.
Nice to 1-3.
There you go. Donald gets it. 1-3. Boom, baby. 2-3. Yes.
It is not affordable.
Americanism, not globalism.
There was a lot of that last night where I'd say something, he'd say it right after. Talk about saints. I mean, obviously he didn't talk to me. This isn't, I mean, his responses last night are all his. They had nothing to do with me. Anyways, let's go ahead and go to the next clip here. This is what the campaign put out, showing how they were all ganging up on him to prove this. Here it is.
Ambassador Stevens.
The question is that the discipline of a good leader?
Six said a lot of things. I mean, I think we should
Mr. Trump, we're going to go on. This is about the audience.
Disaster as a
Mr.
Senator.
Trump,
a
we're going to move on. Oh, please.
You didn't delete him?
Allow her to respond, please.
Personally, what do you think will happen if Aleppo falls?
I think Aleppo is a disaster humanitarian-wise.
What do you think will happen if it falls?
How stupid is our country?
There are sometimes reasons the military does that. Psychological warfare.
I can't think of any.
It might be to help get civilians out.
Getting a subpoena from the United States Congress.
We have to move on, Secretary Clinton. You can respond, and then we got to move on.
We want to give the audience a chance here.
Put in jail, let alone after getting a subpoena from the United States Congress.
Secretary Clinton, you can respond, then we have to move on to an audience question.
Where the primary part of our campaign.
I want to get.
Let me follow on this.
I just want to just one thing. First of all, Hillary, everything's broken about it. Everything. The 15,000.
Please allow her to respond. Brought up the email.
No, it hasn't. It hasn't, and it hasn't been finished.
He got less time. They interrupted him like 100 times.
Nice to one on three.
There you go. And so, with our feed, I'm going to sit here and just point out she's a liar. She's like, I don't avoid taxes. She's got all these secret bank accounts. Warren Buffett is the biggest beneficiary. His company got $438 billion. That's the McClatchy headline. And that was years ago. It's more now. He personally got $20 billion that he then puts in a tax-exempt fund and then takes the money back out. Then he says to people that don't know how finance works, I'm a rich guy and I don't pay enough taxes. Raise taxes on rich people. He means people making $50,000 or more now. Oh, yeah. Hillary wants to raise it on middle class folks and blue collar people. I see people not be able to pay for gas, buy their kids food and tennis shoes. It pisses me off. I want prosperity. These people admit they want to make you poor. That's their plan. That's why I hate them. If I'm in a cafeteria, because I like going to blue collar places like Luby's, and I see old ladies in there that are scrimping and can't buy food. I don't like to make a big deal of it, but I go up to the front and pay for their food. And then I start crying because 10 years ago, people were able to buy themselves food. God, these people are so evil. Why can't America wake up and beat them? Donald Trump's not perfect, but he doesn't want to hurt you and your family. Hillary and Obama want to make you poor and pathetic. We have all their white papers. They hate you. They hate prosperity. They hate God. They hate children. And God damn them to hell. We're going to find the lever to beat these people, and they're going to be beaten. Excuse me. I just get so emotional. Look at her shark face. Have to look at her with that demon face. That's a freaking demon. We're going to have President Linda Blair, people, and I'm not going to go along with it. Excuse me. Let's go to a clip of David Knight breaking down The Honest Abe. You can say what you want about Abraham Lincoln. He was neurotic about owning nothing. He was into all sorts of weird stuff and never lying. But he would talk to one group from their perspective, another group, but that's not lying. Hillary's caught in emails talking about lying to people. She turns that into Honest Abe Lincoln, who was the opposite of her. He was a spiritualist. He was into weird Rosicrucian stuff. He was owned basically nothing. When he died, he had a comb and one cup and a knife and a fork and two suits. Abraham Lincoln is the polar opposite of Hillary Clinton, scrounging, buying crap, having rotting mansions everywhere. Abraham Lincoln grew up in a one-room log cabin. You grew up as the daughter of the Chicago mob boss. Oh, yeah, you didn't know that. It's well known. The whore media won't tell you. Let's play this clip.
Look, now she's blaming... She got caught in a total lie. Her papers went out to all her friends at the banks, Goldman Sachs, and everybody else. And she said things, WikiLeaks, that just came out. And she lied. Now she's blaming the lie on the late, great Abraham Lincoln. That's one that I haven't. Okay, Honest Abe. Honest Abe never lied. That's the good thing. That's the big difference between Abraham Lincoln and you. That's a big, big difference. We're talking about some difference.
Yeah, that was really a good example of Donald Trump really hitting his stride. And, of course, that was a question where they asked him about, asked her, rather, about her statement saying, well, you know, I've got a private policy position, then I have a public policy position. In other words, I've got two different ones, and I lie to the public. I don't really tell them what's really on my mind. And, you know, first she tried to spin it a number of ways. She said, well, I think that's strategic and it's presidential. And then, of course, she did what she always does when she's in deep trouble. She pivots to the Ruskies. She goes on and starts talking about the Ruskies. But Donald Trump didn't let her off. He came back. Oh, she also threw in a thing about, well, I was just referring to something that Abraham Lincoln did. And Steven Spielberg wrote about. He came back and he said, okay, so you're saying that Honest Abe lied to the public. I thought it was a great rhetorical flourish. Absolutely a good example of Donald Trump in command of this debate. For InfoWars.com, I'm David Knight.
Americanism not...
Yeah, they filed those special reports during the lab debate. Let's back that up, because I want to point out something about mind control. That's our old studio. We've loaded images in there that are about 3 years old. We need to put new ones in. But we show the TSA searching people without warrants. We show Nazi Germany doing it. And I've had mainstream reporters in the last couple of years, twice that we're here. I don't even have them here anymore. I don't have time for it. They can make up whatever they want. Being interviewing me in there, because I kind of office out of that radio room. That's kind of my office. That's the room I like to. It's real cold in there, and it's nice and padded walls, and you can't hear anything, and it's a good place to think. So that's kind of my office. So I'll be interviewed in there, and they'll go, excuse me, what's the Nazi thing right there? And because there's a bunch of those showing, you know, the globalists and Homeland Security like Nazis, because they are. I mean, the 68 Gun Control Act was taken from the Nuremberg trials. It was the, you know, Nazi gun control thing from the Weimar Republic that previously dated the Nazis. But they codified it. And twice, I just remember that, they've said, what's that Nazi stuff? Or would you want to explain this? And I look at them and I go, I'm not going to explain that to you. Make it up if I'm a Nazi if you want. Oh, really? And I go, one's the TSA searching somebody. One is the Nazis. You understand, dumbass? That's why I don't even have people. And they get it. They just want to score a point. They just want to be able to say I'm a Nazi. This is how they have no morals. And see, that's one of my blind spots. I just have to get in their mindset where they don't care about real stuff. They just want to find some leverage. They're the high ground. They're the liberals. They're not. They're the fascist. And the Republican Party is just as bad, and they're all against Trump. Duh. I mean, it was like I was up there after I had the Muslims confronting me up on this hilltop shooting a video Saturday titled, Donald Trump Must Attack or Drop Out. And thank God he got it and attacked. And then this guy walks over and goes, I don't watch your show, Alex. He had his wife, and he's like, are you a Christian? And there's this thing where these fake Christians always... Are you a Christian? And I'm like, well, I don't pray up on the mountaintop. I just do broadcasts from it. I'm not like the Pharisees. And then they go, well, you're a Christian? You don't know in the Bible? In the New Testament, Christ's all about the people that tell you how good they are and how perfect they are all day and how much they love God and how they don't commit sins and how they don't do anything and blah, 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 how wonderful they are. And then Christ beats them with whips. He goes, oh, so are you? I go, my God, you didn't even understand what I just said. You're a pseudo intellectual that wants to come over to me. And I mean, Zimmerman was there. I was fit to be tied. I just yelled at the Muslims. And, you know, I yelled at the 6-7 Muslims. I just said, look, you're bugging your eyes out, acting tough, hopping around with your shirts off. You love your damn country so much, get back to it. Oh, you're not laughing now, are you? Because I'm done. I'm through. You people want to shoot your mouths off and start wars that you can't back up. Now you want World War III. I'm not going to stand here and take it, and neither are the American people. Excuse me. Let me just plug now since we're off the break. We need to get funding. We have the very best nutraceuticals anybody can get. I thought everybody wanted to put out the best stuff. Most people just want to put out a bunch of crap, do a bunch of marketing, and have naked chicks dancing around to sell it to you in bikinis or whatever. We got the best selenium. We got the best essential oils combined for lung cleanse. We've got the best DNA Force, BioPQQ, CoQ10, all of it together in that formula. We got 23% off on that. We got the new probiotic, which we believe is the very best out there. It's the best we could ever produce. It's over the top amazing. Get major game changer. It has the whole industry freaking out. Biome defense available. InfoWarsLive.com, InfoWarsStore.com. Find the operation. You've got a guarantee from me. I will rampage against the enemy. Ladies and gentlemen, we are broadcasting worldwide. I am your host, Alex Jones. And at the start of the next hour, I'm going to launch another contest to hang posters around the country. And whoever does the best job shooting video of it, putting it on YouTube, posting it in legal and lawful areas, physically posting it, then shooting video, posting it, so that goes viral, handing them out, sky banners, whatever's legal and lawful, projecting Bill Clinton's a rapist on the side of a wall, Hillary's a traitor, Benghazi, whatever, we'll get $5,000, but we're only running it until next Friday. We don't have a lot of time, so get your videos in. Everybody's going to be a winner. I wrote checks Friday. I'm writing more checks for folks that confront Bill Clinton on his sexual crimes past. $1,000 for having the shirt on for 5 seconds or more on TV, clearly visible. $5,000 if you have the shirt on or the image of Bill exposing his rape history. And then also get it audibly, repeatedly out on national television. But again, it just makes it fun to have the prize, to have the bounty. I'm doing that so Clinton knows where it's coming from. I'm doing that because metaphysically, I need to stand on the bridge against the Borog. I have to physically put myself in the game to get the providence. And your whole life's a ritual, folks. Your whole life's a spiritual war. Your whole life. That's what this is. These are the secrets. You have to put skin in the game. You have to have the will, like Donald Trump has, to be the man in the arena. We can all question over and over again, but he's our champion fighting pure evil. He's clearly for real. He's not perfect. He never said he was. If he'd have said he was perfect, then I had a problem. He said, you know who I am. He did that on live radio. He found this Howard Stern. Oh, my gosh. Oh, oh. Who'd you think you signed on to? He doesn't want war with the Russians. He wants you to be prosperous. He loves God. And he's proven it by his actions. King David had his best friend killed so he could have his wife. But he later repented. And God knew it was real. He said, that's a man from my own heart right there. Did Donald Trump kill somebody's husband to get the woman? I don't think we got real Christians here we're dealing with, do we? Who have real discernment and can see you judge a tree by its fruits. The Clintons are the poison tree. So we're going to get the video slowed down frame by frame by frame. And the response of Hillary Clinton. I need it by today, guys, or I can do it. I'll take a 10-minute break. I'll get the video. I can slow it down on the computer. Because I need it, and I need to put it out iconically with that video tells a million words. Bill Clinton has a history of sexual abuse. He needs to be exposed. We must use this iconic image. We must hit the four winds with it. We must hammer the enemy because they could stage a war. They could release a bioweapon. They could do anything. They could detonate a nuke, the missing nukes from West Texas. They could do anything. The sky's the limit with these creeps. That's why we need the Secret Service and the government people, and everybody watching them. If you see them start to move with criminal activities, call 911. I'm serious. Just like when the nukes were getting taken off, you know, the Air Force base, we got contacted by the police. Yes, I've just said who the source is because they later figured out who it was. It's the base police. There's so much going on. I mean, who do the police call? They know. They call us. Because they know we'll tell the truth. They know. The government's got this whole NSA thing. They've got the threat fusion centers. They're dialed in. I don't like the fact I'm being spied on. But the people of the government know I'm working 18 hours a day. I'm real. I love America. I love freedom. I love God. I'm fighting. I'm real. And it's self-preservation, people. We can't let pure evil take over. We've got two different graphics. I'm going to show them right now, but we're going to launch this next hour. One's posterized. One's just the image. Raping America since 1993. I mean, he's been doing it longer, but he's been raping America as El Presidente. And I'm going to put them on screen for TV viewers. And the next hour, we're going to put an article up with the new initiative. I don't want to call it a contest. It's an initiative for the people to practice taking action and to take the globalist on. That's what this comes down to. Infowars.com is the tip of the spear. We need your prayers and support because so much is happening, obviously. So much is unfolding. I want to play a couple more clips. We're going to our guests. I'm going to give the phone number out and start taking your calls. In fact, I'll do that now. On the debate, what you think Trump did, how you think they're going to strike back, all things Trump, all things America, all things the Brexit, all things escaping the New World Order. That's the topic. It's a big, giant area. That's what we're discussing. 800-259-9231. 800-259-9231 is the number. 800-259-9231. We had 23,000 calls last night that tried to get in. 23,000. People aren't going to believe that. We ought to show our digital record to show people that. I mean, look, even national shows beg for calls. CNN has to beg for calls. We get 23,000. That's probably 5,000 people calling over and over again. But the point is, it just shows how huge this broadcast is. We had close to a million on our own streams. Was it 300,000, 400,000 on the YouTube streams, a bunch of other streams, AM and FM stations? And I'm not bragging, but the point is, mainstream media claims they're the end-all, be-all. They're the little man behind the curtain. Now, continuing, ladies and gentlemen, I want to play a few more of these clips. Let's play this clip where CNN got caught coaching the so-called focus group that they were going to bring in. And then CNN got caught coaching. I mean, it was so clear when that first black lady asked the question that, oh, the moral, how are you going to act for our children? That it was setting it up for Cooper to be able to go, oh, yeah, what about morals? Since she said that, because, again, they were going to have Hillary not shake his hand. And then once that happened, He was going to say, why didn't you shake his hand? Like he's not attacking, you know, straight out. He's fair and balanced. But it blew up in their face because he didn't try to shake her hand. So that's more inside baseball. But here it is, ladies and gentlemen.
America's great. All right, so I want to ask you, what was it about Hillary Clinton's argument that resonated with you following Donald Trump's defense of the video?
She stated that America is already great, and I tend to agree with that. Though we are slow in progressing in a number of areas, we are progressing. We need to continue the momentum.
Now, continuing, ladies and gentlemen, I have another clip I want to get to that's important, that deals with a whole host of these issues. And that's the CNN panel. Hillary did not defend Bill. This is very important because what can she say? He has settled rape cases. He has settled assault cases. He is a sex addict. He is a drug addict. He is completely mentally ill. No one respects him now. Obama's like, get on the plane. What's your problem? Come on. You know, for 5 minutes. I mean, this guy is in his own world. He's looking at people like a psychopath, angry at everybody. So let's go ahead and get to this piece. CNN panel, Hillary did not defend Bill.
He gets to run his campaign any way he chooses. He gets to decide what he wants to talk about. Instead of answering people's questions, talking about laying out the plans that we have that we think can make a better life and a better country, that's his choice. When I hear something like that, I am reminded of what my friend Michelle Obama advised us all. When they go low, you go high.
She got some applause for that line, but I didn't hear a robust vote of confidence, a defense of her husband in that response, because he really went after Bill Clinton.
Hillary Clinton didn't mention Bill Clinton's behavior or actions at all. She didn't defend her husband at all. She just went after, more or less, Donald Trump, essentially saying you're trying to go back, and we're talking about you here. A couple points.
Now, I'm going to spend a few minutes with this gentleman and then start going to your phone calls. We open the phones up, 800-259-9231. Micah Femia is one of the folks that's gotten on national TV exposing Bill Clinton rape. We're going to talk to him here in just a moment. Let's go ahead and play that clip.
Got new music out and, of course, great Throwback Thursday music.
By the way, he doesn't age.
No, he doesn't. No. He looks great. Wow. We're all going to rickroll.
Exactly. A lot to get to in this half hour. Let's.
Now, again, is that as spectacular as a fellow screaming for 2 minutes, Bill Clinton's a rapist and being grabbed and holding on to the fence? No, or a guy climbing over? Doesn't matter. It's just as important. He went out, he took the initiative, he took action, he got it out there, $1,000. But I'm guessing he didn't do it with $1,000. That just makes it more fun. So we've had this happen 14 times I know of. And what we're doing is exposing that they've been raping America physically, economically, militarily. They're the authors of almost everything we've dealt with. They are the special interest point persons controlling the multinational takeover of this country. So Micah has MicahFemia.com. Micah is MicahFemia.com. So we're going to learn who this guy is, one of these other great activists we've been having on. We'll get the lady on soon as we can, who also had the rape shirt and all those other great folks. This is so exciting. And you keep wondering, when's the next one going to pop up? I want to thank Drudge for linking to all these two and helping give it more legs. We're all in this together trying to save the Republic. So, Micah, thanks for coming on today.
Hey, my pleasure. It's an honor, honestly. When I heard the call, when you made the call, I mean, it was just crystal clear. This was for me to do. I mean, it wasn't about the money, exactly like you said. It was about being able to exercise free speech. And I live here in New York in a sea of liberals and trendies, and it's really hard to be a patriot sometimes. But I knew Rockefeller Center, I mean, they feed live every day. So I kind of went in incognito, and I gave myself a whole backstory, and I walked up to the guys and asked if, you know, how much tickets were, and knowing that I could just walk in and have my sign already made up. And it was just a quick, simple 1-2 fold here. And they had no idea, you know, and I wedged my way right in there and I aligned myself with the truth. And watching last night, Trump with some of the women, I mean, that's why I did it. You know, it's for them. It's for giving these people a voice that are just being shut down. I mean, that's not America, but it is, sadly, and they can't stop it all. So if I made some NBC executive pee his pants a little, then you know, I'm happy with that.
Well, Michael, we have to use the term. It's like when I talk about pirate radio, people that have micros call and they go, hey, man, it's micro radio. It's not interfering with commercial stations. Why are you calling it the establishment name? Because the public doesn't know what a micro FM is. I have to say, pirate radio is really micro FM and it's blah, blah, blah. So we have to say liberal. But you seem kind of like an artist type, smart guy, a lot of equipment and stuff in the background for radio listeners. I mean, I'm guessing you sound like an artist. You seem like a smart guy. I mean, I'm a liberal. I like oil paintings. I like red wine. I like classical music. I like to go see a play. I can also, if I got to, beat the hell out of somebody in a parking lot if I have to defend myself. But I also like, you know, riding horses and also like eating barbecue. But I like looking at the stars. I mean, you know, it's like this corner on the market by these fake people because they support the Democrats. They're good. The whole Republican establishment hates Trump. I hate them, too. I mean, I hate the Republicans. I'm a liberal. I'm pro-human, and I'm sick of them being able to even have the mantle of someone that's liberal. Liberal is cutting my taxes in half like Trump's going to do. I'm going to hire so many people, it's going to be crazy.
Yeah, well, absolutely. I mean, I'm completely liberal in my heart, and as an artist, you know, that's the true liberation that we want is freedom, and freedom to go out and be able to speak, and, you know, it's with information that we're going to win this thing, and I feel like right now, Trump, after last night's just destroying of Hillary, anyone that watched that has to know that the national consciousness is figuring out what is actually going on. And it makes me feel like we got to go to the next phase. They're going to definitely steal this and try to steal this because they know they can't win it. Because when you listen to someone's heart, you can tell if they're telling the truth or not. I mean, I was trained as an actor and I learned that it's all from within. It doesn't matter what the words are. And
the way to be an actor is actually tell the truth and become that person and not be an actor.
Exactly. And you can tell when that child actor, you know, she did a pretty good job. She should get a Disney role or something. But when she said, "I see with my own eyes," that line right there was just a pure lie because you didn't see. You didn't know you were a prop in that game. And it's a good sign, I think, because they are desperate. And the look on Bill Clinton's face says it all. I mean, that really is it. They're scared. And when that last guy said, it's undisputable that you're a rapist, I mean, that freeze frame was just incredible. He knows that it's coming. I mean, it's beautiful. It really is beautiful. And
I'm telling you, a slowed down 5-second image of his eyes slowly wheeling in slow motion and then cutting to those women is going to be a devastating 10-second video.
Yeah, that's it. And anyway, we can get the word out. I mean, when you live in a city with millions of people coming and going, you know, I'm definitely going to put that reward money towards some bumper stickers and got to get a little selenium for myself. But, you know, it's going right back in. And I feel like there's no time. If you really believe in what's going on right now, you can't be passive about it and you can't not be emotional about it. And some people are turned off by getting angry or getting too excited or getting too emotional. And I feel like if that's holding you back, then you might as well just go back to sleep, you know?
Absolutely. Being alive is bouncing off the walls. This is what humans were always like. They've taught us just to kind of watch TV and just fade into the, you know, distance and just become these minions. But with a weird lady with a clown head, with a shark face like the Joker, I mean, she could literally be a Marvel comic character, a bad guy, and I just don't get her constituents. I mean, Trump is obviously the real deal, the real, you know, goofball in ways like we all are. But he's gone through all this hell. We put him there to do this. And I'm going to hold his feet to the fire. I don't like some of the things he does, but that's part of how he's real. The difference is with Hillary, it is an act. I've had people that know Trump well. There's not an act with Trump. This is the real deal.
No, absolutely. And anyone that actually watched the debate can see that. If you're reading the papers and they're saying Hillary won, and I mean, I was watching CNN, or I had CNN's website up last night, and they had all these talking points that were anti-Trump that they were reporting on that weren't even discussed yet in the debate. Like, it was like they spelled out their attack.
By the way, they got caught again, double sampling, or right at double. It wasn't quite double. More Democrats than Republicans in the poll, and then Hillary wins. I mean,
Oh yeah.
What's crazy is they think we're so dumb, they admit it's rigged. I mean, it'd be like, again, it's a horse race. It's a mile horse race. There's 7 horses. Her horse is allowed to be a half mile ahead when they open the gates. And then they admit, in our race, we allowed this, you know, Sally Sue or whatever the name of the, you know, the nag is. We allowed her to be halfway ahead when the gates opened. Or Indy 500, we let this race car driver be 250 miles ahead. Or let's be technical, it wasn't quite double. 200 miles ahead in the Indy 500. And then he won by 100 miles. Well, you gave him 200 miles. It means he lost by 100. I mean, it's the insult that they double sample or almost double sample. I mean, how the hell do they do that?
Well, it's right in our face. And that's why they love it, is because they think they're getting away with it. But, you know, if you put it on a scale, I mean, this is the stuff they're throwing at Trump right now. This in the last 30 days, this is the worst that they can come up with. I mean, that's a great saying. I don't. You know, there's a lot of things. He is a man, and I feel like, you know, if you put, you know, a scale of what she's done, the murder, the actual rape, it's...
The jihadi, she's worse than a James Bond villain. I mean, she's like an epic real villain with a League of Doom, a Legion of Doom with George Soros and the Saudis and the Chinese communists and the creepy Pope, and just, it's like, what in the world? All against Trump. How could you not be for him? We'll be back with more. And then we're going to your phone call. Stay there, gentlemen. Amazing patriot. Our forces are hitting the enemy hard. But they've got secret weapons. We've got 28 days, ladies and gentlemen. We know the horse we put in the fight. We know he's a man. He's not perfect. He never hit any of it. We found Howard Stern interviews. You found the secret interviews. My enemies do that, too. They go, we found a tape where Alex Jones admits he's had family in the CIA. We've got him now. And it's like my show, me saying it on air, and how horrible it is, and how horrible they told me it was. I mean, it's like there's all these mentally deficient people, I'm not being mean, who like make up whatever they want, and then they call me a conspiracy theorist. We put airplanes in the sky saying Hillary for president. We put driving billboards all over the place. We had the Secret Service high-fiving us. And I was like, don't do that. You're going to get in trouble. They're like, oh, we don't care. She's a Chinese agent. They've never acted like that. They told us she's having convulsions and falling down. We were finding a video. They took it off CNN where she starts to do it last night. And then she falls down weeks after I tell you because it's real. We really do know Hillary's attack plan on Trump. We really knew that she was planning to not shake his hand last night. Notice it didn't happen. She didn't extend it because Trump didn't extend it. He knew. I mean, we're in the fight. Hillary's attacking us. You are in the fight. You're the listeners. You're the power. You're everything. This gentleman, Micah Femia, they're in New York, going out, putting the sign up, getting it on the news on one of the biggest, highest rated shows. They still have big ratings on those morning shows, 5, 6, 7 million viewers. All of that is having a giant effect. All of it is freaking them out. And you notice Trump said, hey, lock you up. Hillary for president. They asked General Flynn, she should be put in prison? Yeah, Hillary for president. She's a criminal. She's involved with Al-Qaeda. Folks, she expanded Al-Qaeda. It was 20-something countries a month ago. It's 30-plus. There's a global jihad right now. I'm not against the average Muslim. They're people that are just trying to live in peace. But the big, mean, gangster Islamicists by Saudi Arabia's funding are taking over. So I was against the wars in the Middle East. I was against going and doing those bad things to those people and the secular countries like Iraq to put radicals in. Now that radicals are in, we have to oppose that. They're going to bring them in and let them attack us and then take our freedoms. No, you're not. I'm not submitting. I'm not a Muslim. I'm a Christian. I'm an American. I'm a patriot. And I will never submit to you. Going back to our guest, we're going to start the next hour and go right to calls. Micah Femia, MicahFemia.com. Other great points you want to add, my friend?
Yeah, it's Femia, too, by the way. I never actually corrected you originally.
I apologize. How do I always pronounce everything right? How do you say it?
It's Femia.
Femia, like family. Yeah.
Exactly, like family.
All right, so I know a little bit of Latin, but then I always say it wrong. So I mean, does it mean family in Italian?
It does. It actually...
So see, I can't say it right, but I know what it means.
Exactly.
That's how
exactly.
My brain works. I'm a weirdo. Go ahead. Sorry. Familia. Mangia. Go ahead.
I actually lived above a couple of people that were refugees from Yemen, and it was spectacular. One time, we thought we saw something in their apartment, and it took about 5 hours for the cops to finally go and check things out. They interviewed me for 5 hours instead of them. And, you know, it was like 2 minutes. And I'm thinking, this is how we're set up right now? I mean, what if something really was going on? And I had seen some very sketchy behavior going on. And I ended up moving out of that apartment. But it's real to me here. And I feel like everyone needs a cold shower. You know, we got to wake up the whole body here. And that's,
you know what? I talked over you. I want to give you 5 more minutes because you're a really interesting guy. Then I promise we're going to all the callers. But we have Micah Famia. Get it right that time?
You got it.
Okay, good. MicahFamia.com, FEMIA.com. We're going to break right now. Please don't forget, as I barely plugged, you mentioned the selenium. We have the BioTrue Selenium, the very best for mustard seed, InfoWarsStore.com, InfoWarsLife.com. We have 23% off DNA Force. It's about to end in a few days. That's our flagship product. The Biome Defense Probiotic. The Hillary for Prison shirt is about to end. 28 days to get that. And the new Don't Tread on Me Hillary shirt. Lock her up. Limited edition. Made in America. InfoWarsStore.com. Back in 70 to finish up with him. Then more clips, but first your calls. Stay with us. 2 hours left in transmission. All right. Micah Famia is our guest. MicahFamia.com. Famia. And we're going to go to your phone calls right after this short segment. A bunch of other clips, a ton of other news. I forgot to even get into what he mentioned. CNN rigged the latest poll again. But what does your gut tell you about dirty tricks, the next 28 days, where we're going? Obviously, they're going to throw everything they can against us if Trump gets in, too. But we can't just submit and put Hillary in.
She's clearly trying to start something with Russia, and it's ugly. It's something that we have to just keep cracking at those eggs. I mean, I feel like they're trying to boil everyone up, and we got to keep cracking at them, you know, small cracks, big cracks, before they get hard-boiled. Otherwise, it's too late. And, you know, I know my sign wasn't the most heroic. I got in and out peacefully, and it was funny. I even went back. If you watch the footage, there's some blurry signs because it was a close-up behind Savannah. What's her name? You know, these people are blind to it. I was holding up a sign that said Bill Clinton is a rapist, and they didn't even care. I mean, it was like clockwork walking out of there. And I feel like this is biblical. I mean, this is the trumpets are sounding. Honestly, whoever said that last night, I mean, I thought of that too. It's you know, the flies are trying to get in to Hillary. She's pure evil. And if you're not actively trying to wake up at least the people that you love and your family, and that's where it starts. You have to have these conversations, the hard ones, even though, you know, you think that they're so close-minded, you have to keep chipping away and cracking away at it. Otherwise, you're just giving up yourself. And I don't know, I just can't stand by and do that, and that's why I love
it. Well, I agree with you, and that's why I've gotten so emotional. I mean, I'm very cold about my analysis, but the history, what's happening, realizing what's coming if she wins, this is all a manifestation of global resistance to tyranny, the Brexit, Russia, and what's happening here.
Right, right. And I feel bad for, you know, Hillary's granddaughter. I mean, she's an actual person. And this is just, it's pure evil. And it's like, God's working through you. And that's why I've always wanted to thank you, and I know you don't like to be thanked, but I want to thank God right now for working through you and through your team as a vessel. And if I could be anything, you know, a little cog in the wheel, like, I'm going to keep going. And I know that anyone out there, they just have to make the decision. I mean, people told me not to do it. People told me because they doubted if it was even going to be a real thing. And I'm like, are you kidding me? Alex Jones is a man of his word. And you obviously don't know him like that. And this is going down. I can do it. And it's all about mentality. And if we have to we have to stay in that positive mentality that this is it. This is the only chance that we get. Donald Trump is our only way out of this mess. And if it goes to Hillary, it's done. And that really is how drastic we have to think. And everyone needs to get out there. We need to organize. And we need to figure out how to do things with members. I mean, I didn't have anyone else to go with. I could have had a bullhorn if someone would have, you know, passed it over the fence easily. But
sure. Well, we've had $100,000 contests before, and people couldn't believe it when the check actually came. They got on air and they went on their own Skype. They go, look, it came. Last week, we were doing mock checks. They didn't want me to actually sign real checks with the, you know, the numbers on them on air. And I was like, well, some of these guys are getting $5,000 checks. This isn't right. Send them back. So I've actually got to get to that. When I say checks in the mail, I've got to get to it. But it isn't about that. It's about taking action and about the little people are really the big people and doing it and to create the excitement, the electricity that money's involved. I've had a lot of contests where it's not even money's involved. Those are some of the biggest we have. But I'm going to have a $5,000 contest on putting up, you know, different signs about Bill Clinton and about Hillary and Benghazi. because it's about people getting the idea that even if they shut down the media, we can go out and we can do things in public that have an even bigger effect. All right. Well, Micah Famia, thank you so much. MicahFamia.com. We'll obviously talk to you again soon. And hey, do it again. Oh, I should have added, you can win repeatedly. Go-getters, just keep doing it over and over again. Great job.
Plenty more shows.
Great job, my friend. And look, half the time I'm stumbling through this because I'm tired half the time. I'm just doing my best job I can. Well, I appreciate the listeners and the viewers. Your phone calls are 3 minutes away. I'm going directly to you. More clips and a lot more. Stay with us. All right, I'm going right to your phone calls after I play this clip. I'm going to play this clip several more times before the show's over because it's so important. I've already played it once. This is when they bring up 11-year-old edited tape talking about some really gorgeous woman, you know, and the fact, oh, but she was married, so he couldn't date her. It's clear he's saying that. But it doesn't matter. He never claimed to be an angel. We found Howard Stern. It's a secret guy named Howard Stern. He has a secret show, and we caught this secret thing, you know, him being asked dirty questions and responding to it. That's what you do. You go on Stern's show, you plug what you're doing, you talk about your issues, and then he asks you dirty questions. You go, okay, yes, I guess. Oh, yeah, all right, okay, whatever. That's what he does. Okay, all right, back to my hotel, or back to my golf course, or back to where I am on politics. Point is, he went out of his way when it was popular to attack Iraq in 2003, to go on Fox and CNN. We have the clips we played. I'm not going to play them again. You see the media go again last night. You never said you were against the Iraq war. I forgot that part. Yes, he did. And it's wrong to lie about it. But again, they got Howard Stern, 2006, 3 years after it starts. He didn't want to talk about it. So he's just like, yeah, okay, yeah, whatever. I mean, people walk to me in restaurants all the time and I'm tired. It's like 9 o'clock at night. And I'm just eating, and they're asking me political questions. I'm like, yeah. Oh, my gosh, Alex said, whatever. This is the games they play. We know where Trump stands. We know what he's for. But this is what got Bill Clinton so unhappy and got him to flip out. Here is the video of Trump finally fighting back 5 minutes into the debate, when they already hit him three times with how much he hated women for his statement.
Jeff from Ohio asks on Facebook, Trump says the campaign has changed him. When did that happen? So, Mr. Trump, let me add to that. When you walked off that bus at age 59, were you a different man, or did that behavior continue until just recently? And you have 2 minutes for this.
As I told you, that was locker room talk. I'm not proud of it. I am a person who has great respect for people, for my family, for the people of this country.
Good pause.
And certainly I'm not proud of it.
Back in about 5 seconds. Hillary's like, good, he's not fighting back. She's all secure. Good. He's going to let me just attack him. Good, we've got control of him. I can't believe he doesn't understand how weak I am. Good, he's under my control. Good, yeah. But then he just hits her. And she doesn't like it. And we were getting the clip. CNN pulled it. She starts going from another camera angle I saw. I saw it on Facebook, so did do. And when they're out there trying to find it, she starts going, ooh, like she's having another seizure. But Clinton, Bill, the serial rapist, he really freaks. Here it is.
I am a person who has great respect for people, for my family, for the people of this country. And certainly I'm not proud of it. But that was something that happened. If you look at Bill Clinton, far worse, minor words, and his was action. His was what he's done to women. There's never been anybody in the history of politics in this nation that's been so abusive to women. So you can say any way you want to say it, but Bill Clinton was abusive to women. Hillary Clinton attacked those same women and attacked them viciously. Four of them here tonight. One of the women, who is a wonderful woman, at 12 years old, was raped at 12. Her client, she represented, got him off, and she's seen laughing on two separate occasions, laughing at the girl who was raped. Kathy Shelton, that young woman, is here with us tonight. So don't tell me about words. I apologize for those words. But it is things that people say. But what President Clinton did, he was impeached. He lost his license to practice law. He had to pay an $850,000 fine to one of the women. Paula Jones, who's also here tonight. And I will tell you that when Hillary brings up a point like that, and she talks about words that I said 11 years ago, I think it's disgraceful, and I think she should be ashamed of herself, if you want to know the truth.
Absolutely. He goes on to say she should be put in jail. She's clearly a criminal. And Bill Clinton could not stand it. We're getting the video slowed down of him in that epic point where he totally flips out. And it's going to be a major meme we put out. It's a major weapon against these people. And then cut to the women that he's looking at right across the aisle, a bunch of his victims. He can't stand the fact that they've killed their dogs. They've killed their cats. They've threatened their family. They've had their mortgages taken. They've got them fired from jobs. He's harassed them for years. And they just won't back down. He can't stand the fact that he's killed so many people. And so many people murdered. And folks just don't care. They're still fighting. It's going to be a good day. It's going to be a good day when I can go to Bill Clinton's grave and look at it and know justice has been done. I'm not going to piss on his grave because I don't. He's a failure. I'm sad for him. He's a very, very wicked, evil person. He's the type of traitor the globalists lifted up because he was so empty and so evil and would betray this nation. What's got him so scared of Trump? They've smelled his spirit. They don't like it. He hates con artists. He hates scammers. He hates seeing this country run down a rat hole. And he is worldly. I mean, wanting to be wealthy, wanting to be powerful. But that's not a sin in and of itself. It can turn into something bad. But he's the ghost of Christmas present. Prosperity. If you want to get into a allegory from fiction. And they don't like that. Let's go ahead. We go to Lamar, Josh, Dan, Don, Dan. Let's go ahead and go to Josh in Pennsylvania, and then we'll go to Lamar. You're on the air, Josh.
Hey, Alex, how are you?
Oh, man, I'm super fired up to the point I can hardly stand it. I mean, it was great to see that comeback. If he stays on the attack for 28 days and just doesn't apologize for anything and just hammers the hell out of them, he's going to win. They'll try to steal it, and I think that'll blow up in their face, too. What do you think?
Brother, he killed it. I mean, he was exactly what we need. There was two points I wanted to say about what happened last night. One, when she continues to make these negative, disparaging remarks, saying that he's a racist. I really want him to make the connection of her, because he did it in the first
and Robert time, Byrd.
Bring up these. Well, the super predator remark, and then correlate that directly into the prison sentences that her and her husband helped implement.
And the blood, selling the AIDS blood. That's not been brought up.
Yes. Yeah, I agree. Those are two things that he needs to kind of focus on. And the other thing, you know, my own personal experience, I fought a 10-year fight with the federal government, but working for a company for 6 months, it was a housing market mortgage fraud thing. That being said, after fighting them, I worked for them for 6 months. After fighting the government for almost 10 years, I finally had to plead, because if I didn't plead, they were coming after me for 14 years. And it's exactly what he said. If somebody would have done a fifth of what she did, they'd end up in federal prison. My probation.
Oh, absolutely. The average apartment manager routinely has Homeland Security threatening to arrest them for no reason. They've written the laws where they can selectively enforce them where nothing's legal. But then they let insiders do whatever they want.
And the last thing I want to also talk about, too, is about the race relations. So, you know, my best friend, who and I were both in federal prison together, he's African-American. Let me tell you.
Yeah, you just say that. You don't really have any black friends. Say that because you're so racist. Well, leftists, though, they can be liberal, and then their black friends are real.
Well, the irony is that this is the true racism I've seen more and more, and it's so proliferated in the African-American community, is African-Americans against other African-Americans, and that's the truth. And that's something that doesn't want to be brought up.
Why do you think there's such an epidemic of black-on-black crime? I mean, it's been bad for 50 years, but it's really exploding.
I think so much of it also has a lot to do with the way the media, the way pop culture is. You know, they focus the attention on if you're not a thug or a gangster or doing something of some illegal aspect or being involved in sports, then you're not really black. And that to me is absolutely absurd. If you're articulate, you're intelligent, you choose to
have... No. It's like, have you ever seen crabs at the beach? You catch a bunch of crabs and they don't attack each other till one tries to get out. It's the weirdest thing. I don't care what crab species it is. When one tries to climb out, they come over and grab them.
It's amazing.
It's horrible.
Look, I watched it. My friend, he would get it all the time, telling him that, you know, he's Uncle Tom, he's whitewashed. And his response would be like, why? Because I chose to not be associated with this concept of what quote unquote Black America is. So again, I leave you with that, Alex. Thank you so much. Again, by the way, the team that you put together, you know, David Knight, Leanne McAdoo, you know, Owen Shorter, all these guys, I've been listening to you. You woke me up in 2006, right before I got indicted, which is ironic. And I got to tell you, the team you put together is absolutely fantastic.
Well, let me mention a team. I mean, Ashley Beckford's Black. You know, her ancestors are from Africa. She's a human. And you get into these terms, but that's the left creates it all about terms, the opposite of Martin Luther King. She goes out and just mildly asks questions about Hillary. White people, you name it, scream, you're an Uncle Tom. They're the big racist. And they get off on the fact that they're liberal so they can say whatever they want. You know, it's like gay people can go, you're a faggot, you're a queer, you're a blah, blah, blah. Anybody else says it, it's bad. And it just perpetuates this whole thing when all they are is actually racist, operating in a racist world, but saying they're good. I mean, it's actually crazy. It's nuts.
Everything we're seeing right now, I listen to NPR and it disgusts me because it's supposed to be nationally public radio. And all I hear is them bashing Trump. All they're doing is pushing the race, white privilege, this. You know, it's unbelievable the nonstop race baiting that.
Oh, yeah. All they care about is thinking they're in the winning team. All right, brother. Great call. Appreciate your call. Let's talk to. Again, we're talking about the debate last night. How'd you think it went? What's the next dirty trick to come? Is everybody still on the hoax of Friday that, oh, my God, 11-year-old tape with some racy dog. Oh, it's over. This is Donald Trump. He's been married to 3 supermodels. He's got a whole bunch of kids. He doesn't drink. He doesn't smoke. He eats big, juicy ribeye steaks and ice cream and eats milkshakes. And plays golf and likes women. So Bill Clinton likes to rape women. He likes women. Hillary likes women, but that's okay that she's in the hotel room with Uma Abedin and she's more tail than a toilet seat. That's all right. It's just that Donald Trump is, it's hypocrisy. Okay, make him stand down. Hillary needs to be arrested. I tell you what, you arrest Hillary, you charge her, then I'll say Trump's a bad guy. This guy has a speeding ticket. Donald Trump, this person murdered people. Well, arrest the speeding ticket guy. It's just insanity. Lamar in Tennessee, thanks for calling.
Hey, Alex, good to talk to you again. I really wasn't going to vote for Trump. And, and not because of all the typical nonsense that you hear people say that he's a racist and his taxes and all this kind of ridiculous stuff.
But that he's too liberal? Was it because he's too liberal? Because that could be true.
No, I mean, I'm very libertarian, and I feel like he could have easily won this election by tweaking his campaign a little bit and really preaching about adhering to the Constitution and all the things I wanted to hear. I was never quite hearing out of him, and so I was.
Well, I mean, he did say a lot of that. In fairness, the media didn't cover it. I've seen incredible things he said that never get on the news. So, in fairness, have you been following his speeches?
Yeah, I mean, I listen to him a lot, and I don't agree with him. I don't agree with him on a lot of things, you know, like Edward Snowden and everything.
I agree with you there. I agree he shouldn't be talking about the torture, but it's also then good that he's so honest about it. He's like, we're doing it. They're terrorists. You know, and he needs to change that. I agree.
Yeah, and so, I was looking, always looking for some kind of a cue or signal, you know, to say, okay, is this guy really his own man? Is he really going to follow through at least with the things we can agree on? And when he on live national TV in the middle of the debate went against his own running mate, you know, Mike Pence, that I personally was not that happy that he picked. I was looking for somebody a little more edgy. And
but let me guess, you like the fact he said we don't need to have war with Russia?
Exactly, 100%.
No, listen, he's got problems and he's very pig-headed, okay? That's why they hate him. He's for real. Now, he has some views that I think are wrong, but he thinks you're right. But let me tell you, he's for real, man. He wants to make us prosperous. He doesn't want to attack people that aren't our enemies. He has a real sense of justice, okay? And that's why they're so scared of him, bro. So I'm glad you're seeing that. Go ahead.
Yeah, anybody that falls for this thing about Russia, I mean, you really got to be simple-minded. You're the most gullible. I mean, this whole thing about Russia is manipulating our election.
Yeah, no, I mean, Russia in the 50s was trying to take us over. Russia is falling apart. They're trying to become free market. They're promoting Christianity and having kids. They're the opposite of the leftist globalist system, and that's why the leftists hate them.
Yeah, and I think now that he's done that, he's kind of put himself in a box. He can't go back on that one. I mean, he threw his running mate.
Well, let me tell you, if the Russians pull anything, and there's different camps, they may do something, you know, some military provocation Putin doesn't know about. There's lots of sabotage. Trump will get angry, and we'll do it, and we'll go with his generals. The good news is he's got the best generals there are advising. He's not an idiot. He's an executive. He goes, gets the top people. I mean, let me tell you, Trump's going to change the world if he gets in. They're probably going to kill him. And so I'm glad you're starting to. I mean, what I'm getting is, Lamar, you weren't going to be for Trump, but now you are.
Right, definitely not. I was not, and I only am because of this one thing. It gives me.
And that's enough, isn't it? Not having World War III. God bless you. I appreciate you. Absolutely. Look, Democrats that are reasonable people, top liberal professors that, you know, head up the Russian studies group say, we need Trump. This guy's good. I mean, the neocons that run Obama and Hillary are crazy people. The guy they followed out of Chicago Business School was a Nazi. And, man, that's what gets really weird. Like, some of these guys are, like, Jewish Russians and stuff that were Trotskyites. Then there's, like, weird Nazis. And then this weird Nazi guy, Speer. And they're over there at Chicago Business saying, in justifies the mean, Machiavellian. And they're just, these students went to this and just got whacked out, man. And so much of our problems come out of this. I mean, you mix Nazism with communism and then weird Jewish socialism. I mean, it's just nasty, 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 nasty. And, of course, there are a lot of neocons that aren't Jews. Because, oh, you're anti-Semitic. I mean, it's a fact that it's a Jewish contingent of weirdo Nazis. And that's what I'm saying. It's so weird. It's like George Soros. He made his first, you know, 100 million robbing Jews for the Nazis. It's like the worst. It's just. And I have liberal Jews go, well, he had to or they'd kill him. And I'm like, I'm not going to. If somebody said, oh, we're going to kill you if you don't say go kill Mexicans, I'd say, well, pull the freaking trigger, dumbass. Ain't doing it. You know, it's this idea of like, he was going to die. No, he wasn't. He went. His dad was involved with him. He was a piece of crap. He could have gotten out of the country. I mean, George Soros is a monster. Dan in Washington, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Hey, Alex. Good long-term subscriber, first-time caller.
Thank you for the support, brother.
Yeah, you've got to always have. Listen, I just want to preface this by saying, you know, I'm a non-Christian, but I saw something today that was forwarded to me that I just had to share with you, and it's a prophetic picture of Donald Trump. And this minister is talking about being saw a little blurb on Trump being the 45th president of the United States, which he would be. And he was called to read Isaiah 45. And the funny thing about Isaiah 45 is it references Cyrus, who is a heathen king anointed by God to protect the Jews and rebuild Jerusalem. Who does that remind you of? Trump is no preacher, but he may be just an anointed guy that's going to disrupt this whole thing.
I totally agree. Now, that's it. That is exactly how the universe works. I mean, I've experienced this. I mean, because you can sit there and say, I hate these preachers. I hate these fake religious people. Of course it's bull. But then there's weird stuff in the universe going on. I've experienced it. God's real. It's whatever you want to call it. There's providence. It's energy. It's a will. That's, I mean, you look at, like, Revelation talks about the Trump and the all of it. It's very, very biblical, but I haven't seen that. Let's pull up, what is this particular graphic? What's the name of it so we can pull it up for folks?
Well, the article was on charismanews.com. It was forwarded to me by my son, who's a pastor, and the thing just stood out at me when it said prophetic picture of Donald Trump, and it, when you read what it says, how Isaiah, 150 years before Cyrus's birth, declared through a prophet Isaiah that a foreign man, a non-Jew named Cyrus, would be anointed shepherd of his people and rebuild Jerusalem, beginning in the first phase of the house of the Lord. I read through this and I go, again, I'm not a Christian, but I think prophecy is fascinating. And if you don't keep your eyes and ears open, you're not going to hear things that just might be a big deal.
Guys, let's pull up Isaiah 45 on TV if we can. There it is, prophecy. God sent Donald Trump to wage war against destructive spirits. You scroll down, and that's it. He wants to build. Boy, they get it. He wants to build. He wants to be prosperous. That's what God gives you. That's the fruits. And he's not perfect. Well, the enemy wants to tear us down and then rule us. Let's put it back on screen from Isaiah, and I'll go back to you. But I want to read this because since you mentioned it. Can we put that back on screen? Thanks, guys. It goes on, and yep, there it is, absolutely, Isaiah 45. That is really wild, isn't it?
I figured God can use any tool he wants to use. And so I saw this, and the first thing I thought of as I was listening this morning is I got to call our brother down there in Texas and get the
word. Sure, but you say you're not a Christian. I mean, I would say I don't believe in this religious system, but I believe in Christ.
Well, I'm a non-believer, but I always have my eyes and ears open because, searching.
Sure, well, what happens if you say have a dream, and then a month later the exact dream comes true?
There you go.
But have you ever had that experience?
I have had that experience where I feel like I'm being talked to. And again, I question it. Where is that coming from?
A lot of people, I've had dreams, okay, where 100% it comes true. And when it's happening, like I had a dream a month or so before, and I was like, this weird dream of this guy with a pink and green striped polo shirt, and I'm walking around this building. I don't know why I'm there. And then he comes out and mugs me, attacks me. And then as it happened, it was just so surreal. And I've had those dreams over and over again. I mean, I've told people this. I had dreams they blew up the World Trade Center. I didn't say that on air. I said they're going to blow up the World Trade Center and blame Bin Laden and launch this big war on July 25th. It's on video. It's on YouTube. And, I kept having dreams of the towers collapsing and blowing up. I didn't tell anybody that but my wife at the time. And she's like, what, they're going to blow the towers up? And I went on air and said it. I said, they're going to blow the towers up. But, I mean, I saw that. So what's going on? Let me tell you, there's a lot going on hidden in the books. To quote William Shakespeare, I forget, it's like in Horatio or one of those. And they kind of repeat it, Master and Commander. Like, as soon as they throw the guy's body overboard and he's dead, all the bad luck ends and the wind comes back and they say, whoa. And he says, the doctor, Master. And he goes, yeah, a lot of stuff in the world hidden in your books, buddy. We'll be back. I think it's what Dr. Pechenik said last time. He's quoting Bismarck. God loves. We'll quote it when we come back. Raping America since 93. We're up to $30,000 now. I'm paying out for folks that have raided Clinton events, screaming Bill Clinton's a rapist, wearing the rape shirt, available at InfoWarsStore.com. Now, we're not going to sell enough of the shirt probably to pay off the deal. I don't care. I'm all in, spending everything I've got, all our reserves, against the enemy right now to promote nationalism and sovereignty and liberty worldwide. I am all in, committed at every level. I promise we'll finish up with Mike, Don, Steve, and Dan with Dr. Pechenik. We'll go 5 minutes the next hour, then hand the baton to David Knight with more highlights from last night. We're going to talk to Pechenik here in just a moment. But before I go any further, there is a new WikiLeaks. In fact, I accidentally left it in my office dealing with dead bodies. I was told Biggs was bringing it over. So much is happening. There's also a new WikiLeaks. So just have them bring it to me again. It's not here. Thanks. New WikiLeaks emails. Clinton campaign insiders fears Bill's sex life could sink Hillary. And they're in there talking about covering it up. The rapes, all the rest of it. That's why they're preparing all this to go after Trump. By the way, I've done investigations into Trump with women that he was formerly known to be with. I'm just going to be honest, before I endorsed him over a year ago. And I talked to Hollywood folks. He's very straight-laced. He's a one-woman man. And he is super conservative privately. And then when he's around liberals and stuff, he'll kind of do some of this jocular talk. But if you really listen to it, I thought she was really beautiful. I wanted to take her and buy her furniture. That's how he thinks she gets women. Not putting Trump down, but it sounds a little amateurish for me. They turn this into this giant, ridiculous garbage when Hillary is helping, pedophiles cover up their rape of 12-year-olds. She admits she knew he was guilty. Funding jihadis, all the sexual crimes. Bill Clinton, with the rapes being settled. We're pouring through the latest WikiLeaks that came out today, so look for more in the next few hours from Blumenthal and others. It talks about a lot of bodies being buried. Now, does that signify literal bodies? Well, yeah, or metaphoric bodies, things that are hidden. I'm not going to belabor this because I want to go to Pechenik. I want to go to your calls, but we're listener-supported. We developed a bio-true, and that's a term I came up with. Not a scientist, but the scientists are saying, no, this is the most bioavailable mustard seed processed in a cold format, not heated up, not adulterated. It's ridiculously strong. I'll be honest. I'm just going to be honest. Everybody loves Brain Force. It sells more than this. To each man, his own. One man's poison is another person's ambrosia. I like Brain Force. It's great. It's got some stuff that's, prescription in Europe. It's amazing. It's healthy. It's great. I don't like it as much, and it makes me a little irritable. Selenium is this trace element involved in electrochemical activities in the brain and all their cells. You die without it. Most people are heavily deficient in it. Last night I was exhausted after being on air 5-6 hours. I had to go another hour. I went, oh, yeah, don't drink coffee. I don't even drink coffee now, pretty much, maybe once a week if I'm having breakfast for the flavor. I take selenium. So it's kind of, for me and my physiology and my biology, my metabolic system, better than our nootropic Brain Force. But now, to each person their own. But Supermel Vitality, the BioTrue Selenium, 23% off DNA Force with the BioPQQ, the CoQ10, and more. InfoWarsLife.com, InfoWarsStore.com, or call toll-free 888-253-3139. And we're going to end the Hillary for President shirt because, you know, it's a great idea we launched over a year ago. It's a huge meme. Trump brought it up last night. It's great. I just, all good things come to an end. Everybody else is copying it. That's fine. But if you want the original with the red InfoWars on the shoulder and the legalized freedom on the back, InfoWars.com, get it today, and the profit we make will fund the operation. We need the funding. Thank you all for your support. You see what we're doing. Thank you for your prayers. There isn't a better place to put your support. And I don't say that arrogantly. I say that humbly. I cannot believe we are the most effective force out there other than DrudgeReport.com. I wish there was 10 other groups more effective. It is a creepy feeling. But it's also very good. Quite frankly, as a man, I'm putting it all on the line. The Bullrog's coming across the bridge. I don't care. It's actually, I'm really alive. I feel guilty if they do something to me for my kids, but just what, I'm all in. It's done. I'm going next level attack. I'm not pulling any punches. I'm going my gut, my research, my heart, my intellect, and I'm just all in. And that's why you see we're even more aggressive now, because I am a madman now. 18 hours a day. I am not stopping. I'm going all the way right through this election. No matter what happens, the fight is on. InfoWarsLife.com, InfoWarsStore.com, or 888-253-3139. You can feel the spirit of liberty and renaissance in America rising. And liberty's rising worldwide. The evil is rising as well against it. But it is a epic time to be alive. Now, I love it when Pachinik wants to come on, because I'm usually trying to get him on. Former head of psychological warfare of the State Department. Held high positions in the State Department, worked for other agencies, helped found with General Boykin, Delta Force, best-selling author Tom Clancy's co-writer and was main source, composite character Jack Ryan, overthrew countries, blah, blah, blah. We don't need to go into all that. People know he's a smart guy. They've seen how much he talked about come true. I'll tell you, he wasn't really a real popular guest 15 years ago. He's like CFR and stuff. He's out of that now, but you know, people didn't get it. Now they really love him, the listeners do, because they get he really knows what he's talking about. So we don't have a lot of time. I got callers I promise we'll go to, but just a gestalt, a snapshot. I don't know your view yet. StevePachinik.com. We'll put your Twitter up as well. What was your view on last night? I think he's himself. He was devastating. It was perfectly done. I'm afraid they're going to kill him. I mean, this is beautiful.
Well, let me just say thanks for allowing me to come on again. I'm fighting with you and the people, but I thought it was brilliant. This was exactly what I was waiting for. I have to thank Steve Bannon and Josh Kushner for doing the most brilliant psychological operation I've seen in a long time, putting the four women there before the debate, putting them during the debate, and Trump was on the offense. He was polite. He was direct. And he clearly stated what the issues were.
He was like a surgeon, because I know you're a doctor.
That's correct. It was a surgical strike, irrespective of all the nonsense about the comments afterwards, which were nonsensical. What Trump was providing was our voice for our revolution, which is far greater than the Republican Party. And as I've said repeatedly over a year and a half, the Republican Party is finished. It's not relevant. We who fought from the day one since 9/11 and created the Tea Party, helped you with the Alex Jones Show, have now a spokesperson for that revolution. That revolution will continue. He indicted Hillary. He said, you're going to prison. He was right. She is going to prison. Ironically, Comey of the FBI, the only success he's ever had besides destroying the FBI, destroying the Department of Justice, was to indict and convict Martha Stewart for obstruction of justice.
Well, she did nothing.
And lying. Can you believe that? But he couldn't do that for Hillary Clinton. Trump brought out the fact that John Brennan, the DNI, Loretta Lynch of the Attorney General, the entire system.
He brought up Hillary supporting rapists. He brought up how they're working with ISIS. He just he,
well,
he was
he, he, he
enumerated the whole thing, and the liberal press cannot handle it. But I want to go back a little bit before Bill Clinton. There is a history in the Democratic Party of fornication in the White House. Let's start with LBJ, who continuously seduced a group of women.
Or Kennedy.
Well, way before that, more importantly, because LBJ seduced Doris Kearns Goodwin, this beloved historian of the left wing who continuously writes about Lincoln. Then you have JFK, who was an Addison's disease, had amphetamines, vitamins, and shots on a daily basis, was not a good lover, repeatedly had women in the White House. And let me quote Colin Powell, General Colin Powell, who said that Hillary is a disaster with hubris. No matter what she touches, it always gets screwed up. And he then added, excuse my language, and her husband's continuously dicking women in their household. That's Colin Powell.
Well, also, I mean, it's confirmed by everybody. Secret Service, FBI, Blackwater folks, special forces that have guarded her. They said she blows up constantly. We're talking carpet chewing, you know, screaming, yelling over nothing. She's, as a psychiatrist, what is this? These blow-ups?
She is sick. As a psychiatrist, I have said repeatedly, and as a neurologist, she has Parkinsonism. She cannot run for the presidency of the United States. I, again, compel her doctor, who was a disaster in her diagnosis, and Columbia Physician Surgeons to release the information to show that she has Parkinsonism. You could see yesterday, she continuously smiled, looked up.
She had to sit down. She had to sit down, basically.
She had to sit down, but remember the same man who ends up as the CIA guy to fix her panel was there at the end all the time. She has to read her answers. She could not handle an active, vigorous campaign. She has not flown. She cannot fly. She cannot really exert any energy throughout an eight-hour day.
Exactly. She's going to be off for 20 days, they announced last week. We're like five in.
This is a crime, and this is where the FBI individuals have to break out, the CIA has to break out, the military officers have to break out.
Exactly. Now is the time to start disregarding this criminal group that's hijacked the country. You're an American, this is not mutiny. We have to stop going with these people.
No, this is not mutiny at all. This is a real revolution in a way that we haven't seen since 1776 because corruption has permeated the Republican Party through this effete, insignificant man, Paul Ryan, and the other man, Frankenkopf. It was so
Isn't
stupid.
That an endorsement of Trump, that he has these horrible neocons and these nobodies and these sycophants of the establishment against him? That's a good thing.
I think it's brilliant because what he has done is to recapitulate the fact that all these neocons, the Wolfowitzes, the Pearls, the Steve Hadleys, the John Boltons, none of whom served in our military, all of whom avoided our service in Vietnam, nevertheless, under the auspices of the Israeli Mossad, have come to the United States with dual citizenship, including Chertoff, Giuliani's right-hand prosecutor, and created a 9/11 standout. This is still the effect of what happened when America realized, thanks to you and others, that we had our own government kill our own people. This is the aftermath. But the Republican Party is so stupid, so inept, that they can't put a handle around it. They didn't realize that.
I agree. Okay, so we've done postmortem on this. How do you expect him with 27 and a half days to strike back? A false flag, they try to kill him, a fake false flag on Hillary, more fake, you know, lawsuits with Jane Doe's.
They can try whatever false flag. It's now irrelevant. Hillary's not even relevant anymore. She is sick, incapable of...
But she is relevant that they would try to put that walking corpse in shows how arrogant the establishment is.
Well, they can put whatever corpse they want, but Trump will blow it out. Now I understand that he really does understand psychological warfare, and he is effectively using it and will continue.
Well, let me give you the news then. You may not know this. You probably do with your sources. I've confirmed he got convinced by family. The Clintons lied to them and said, let's play nice. Let's not go there. That's why he did that at the last debate. Now he understands, and he's told some of his family that mean well. It shows he's a good guy. He listens to his family, but it's also kind of a bad thing. He just said, look, sit down. Watch what I do. So now we're seeing Trump be Trump, and he needs to just stay that way.
That's exactly right. And I think Kushner and I think Bannon have done a brilliant job, and Ms. Conway as well, of steering him right to the right direction. And now the American public has to understand this is not about a person. This is not about a personality as much as it is about a dynamic that...
Exactly. He's a figurehead. It's the old establishment. Sure. We know they're bad. Doesn't matter what they throw at Trump now. He's our figurehead.
That's correct. He is the articulation of what you and I and many of others have said. We are tired. We're sick of it. We no longer want to follow what this country has been doing and what the leaders. You have Obama, CIA, a bred infant. Clinton, another CIA bred infant. Bush Jr., a disaster, another CIA. This is the end of the CIA and its capability to insert into our presidency the people that they've nurtured and created. In turn, we have Michael Flynn of the Defense Intelligence Agency, and she has, on the other hand, somebody not as capable, Michael Hayden. But now we have a confrontation between the civilian intelligence and the military intelligence, which is what I've said for a long time. It's time that our military intelligence took over, did not follow the precepts of an incompetent Catholics in Action, or CIA, and just put our country into a steady stream of effectiveness. I still go back to General Eisenhower. It was Eisenhower who, as a general, said, beware of the military-industrial complex. It was Eisenhower who went to Korea and stopped the war that Truman, a Democrat, created. It was Eisenhower who warned of a potential war.
And who tried to fix race relations, which the Democrats then seized on and weaponized.
Correct. Now, the fact that Hillary's using Putin as a false emblem of nastiness and bitterness is the fact that she is inept. She has always been inept as Secretary of State.
I agree, but let's go back to Eisenhower, because it seems like everything good came out of him. And we saw shadows of it, like he stabilized Iraq, Egypt, put in groups that were secular, and then the CIA changes its policy and overthrows those to put jihadis in to destabilize it all, I guess, to have some place to bomb. Is that correct?
That is absolutely correct. Eisenhower warned America of the CIA's detrimental force to our country. He warned Alan Dulles, and he reprimanded him and the other individuals because he had General Biddle Smith. And he had created his own psychological operations within the White House, which he kept away from the CIA. He didn't like the work. He didn't like who they were. He himself was exactly what America was, Midwestern, modest, not grandiose, in no way was he interested in money. He was 59 years old when he was a colonel under Douglas MacArthur, one of the biggest pains in the ass that we've ever had as a general. And he effectively led a war in Europe. He then returned to become president of Columbia University, not the head of a company, not the head of some corporation, didn't take money at $600,000 a shot the way Hillary did or Bill, and went on to become president of the United States. He had Nixon. Nixon had shortfalls, but having worked with him, I've got to tell you, he was a brilliant man. And considering they call him Tricky Dick, in comparison to Hillary, he was only missing 18 minutes versus Hillary's 32,000 emails.
That's right. All right. I'm going to come back and take a few calls in two final segments. You can ride shotgun with us. I appreciate you being here, Dr. Pachening.
No,
David Knight's taking over. I want to go to these calls, but we're about to go to break. Let me just ask you this quick. They're going to strike back, though, and they run these hoaxes that he's got to step down. How do we get the public not to buy into that?
Because they avoid it and just continuously support them and listen to you and work on what we need to do for ourselves.
But you're really confident we're going to be able to beat him? I mean, I know he's going to win, but they're going to try to steal.
We can beat him. The next 30 days is very important because, remember, 30 days in 21st century is an accelerated period of time. I want the people to go out, to vote, to watch the electoral booths, and to keep on supporting him. She is finished. She's physically and mentally not capable of traveling, not capable of answering.
No, I understand. But the elite are so arrogant that they're going to try to just steal it and put her in there. What happens if they try to steal it when we come back? I mean, Trump's going to fight it, obviously. But, CNN has openly fake polls where they have almost double sampling for Democrats. I mean, this is unprecedented. All right, Don and Mike, I'm going to you. Dr. Steve Pachenik of StevePachenik.com is our guest. And let's put his Twitter up on screen so I can plug that too. I'm Alan Jones, InfoWars.com. This is a huge time to be alive. This is real. I've not been excited about other elections because it's just two wings on the same bird. This is different. Seismic. It's global. It's important. We need new management. This isn't even about, you know, parties or anything. This is about a corrupt elite, disconnected, smoking their own dope. But briefly, in 30 seconds, Dr. Pachinik, I understand you're putting a good face on it. I agree. We're in very positive waters. The general public needs confidence. They get roped into these stampedes like lemmings. But for our listeners, who you know, aren't your average duck, they understand what's going on. I mean, I really want to know, from your perspective, how you think they're going to strike back. I mean, I get the fact trying to run this sick, crazy woman just shows they shouldn't be in office. But at the same time, they're still going to try this. They're still going to run this thing. They're still going to try to steal it. So what do we do?
Well, what we do is, number one, I would love to see the honorable men and women of the FBI who've been compromised by a corrupt boss, James Comey, to come out on their own and basically state that
Leak.
They no longer believe in their leader and that he's
Ooh, imagine a press conference. If 100 of them stood together, you couldn't fire them all. It'd be over.
Well, that's my point. And it's time for the American citizen who works for the CIA, for the
Exactly.
FBI.
Why do you and I have to be the ones hanging our ass out here? And I'm not bragging that we're heroes, but where is that survival instinct?
You and I, it's very simple. You and I don't have a pension. We're not guaranteed our livelihood. You and I know that we have to hustle every day for our living. We don't have a guaranteed life cycle. But the FBI individual thinks that he or she is going to be given, going to be taken care of for their whole life, get a pension. It's just not going to happen.
But you said it. They are discrediting it with a mortal wound. They can't put this back together again unless they turn against it.
Well, they have to. There's no other alternative. And I know many of the FBI career officers, and they have to remember, James Comey was never an FBI agent. He was never a special agent.
He's a Politico.
He was a prosecutor. And he was a lawyer, and he was a compromised lawyer, along with Sandy Berger and Cheryl Mills and all the
others. But you're right. The next 28 days, we need people now to do the right thing, folks.
That's
do
correct.
It.
The first thing I would say, I'd like the FBI people to walk out and say, look, we no longer can support Comey. There are those in the CIA who can say the same thing about John Brennan. There are those in the military who could say, look, we're standing up for what we believe in. But they can defy orders. If the orders and the people are incompetent or corrupt, there is an obligation in the Constitution for us to fight the men.
That's in the Declaration of Independence. You're right. Don in Texas, you're on the air with Dr. Steve Pachinik. Go ahead.
Hey, Alex, it's good to finally be able to talk to you. Hey, you termed Hillary the walking corpse. In fact, when I saw that fly crawling all over her face, the first thing that came to mind was rotting demon flesh.
I mean, I've been saying she's like a reanimated corpse for a while. I don't know what drugs they got her on. That's a good question for Pachinik. How could she be not able to even be in public for a while and do okay at these debates? She has to rest for weeks and weeks as a physician. What
well,
are they doing?
There's another issue that you brought out a long time ago, and I think that she may be receiving blood transfusions, which has been known in the past to revive certain people for a certain amount of time. But if you looked at her at the end of the debate, she was very tired. She was
exhausted. She was having to sit down. There was a few minutes. We've got clips coming up where she kind of blacks out.
Correct. And then that CIA operative, who's their lawyer, so to speak, but he worked in Africa and elsewhere, comes in and takes out her notes. It's the same guy you see all the time.
Absolutely. Great point, Dr. Pachinik. Don, go ahead. Anything else? Yeah, it's like she's a pile of dead flesh.
In that post-debate interview, she looked like she had about had it. Her eyes were bugged out and going in different directions. And, I mean, I think she reached the limit of her drugs, yeah.
It just shows the hubris. Why didn't they get a better candidate? Because it's her turn. It's her turn, Dr. Pachinik, isn't it? So we have to run a corpse.
Well, the point is that she's so ruthless and the machinery is so corrupt that they've compromised everybody in the government, including Comey, Loretta Lynch.
Yeah, they're their own worst enemy. They don't get it. I mean, at the end of the day, they're the ones bringing them down. We just want to stop nuclear war. Thank you, Don. Mike and others, your call 70 seconds away with Dr. Pachinik. Then we've got David Dyke coming in. Get ready. Let's go ahead and take a few more phone calls with Dr. Pachinik. Then I'm going to play a special clip of slowing down of Clinton looking like a crazy person. And again, he is a crazy old creepy man, but this image, we're going to put it out everywhere. It's going to be very powerful against the enemy. So get ready. Infowars.com is the coordinates. It'll be up in the next few hours. You'll see it first here if you're a TV viewer in a few minutes. Right now, Dr. Pachinik's our guest, taking a few calls. Let's talk to Mike in Illinois. You're on the air. Go ahead.
Yeah, hi, Alex. I appreciate all you're doing for the Republic. Have you ever read George Washington's Vision?
Yes, I have.
The United States?
Please don't thank me, though. I'm bailing water. We're in the same boat, brother. I just keep explaining. The reason they don't thank me is this is survival. So thank you for being awake. I'll say that. But that's why they don't thank me. We're in a survival war here.
I know.
I don't want to be in North Korea run by crazy Hillary with a big rubber head.
Yeah. The last vision, though, it's, you know, the whole world comes against the United States, which means we don't go along with the globalists, you know. So I think that means Trump's going to get in there because we're not going along with
their game plan. No, I agree. The world's destiny, as the prophet said, stands and will fall or stand with the United States. I think it was Pechenik said the quote. I looked it up. It was from Bismarck that what God loves, you know, drunks, children, and the United States of America. Dr. Pechenik?
That's correct. We will survive. I mean, we are so unique in the world that we have an ability to change very quickly and ability to change our leadership and still continue as an effective republic. No other country can do that.
Why are they so obsessed? I mean, I know you helped bring down the Soviet Union. They've got their own problems, but Russia seems much less problem than China. Why is there an obsession with Russia? Is that because the neocons, the roots of that, got kicked out of Russia?
Yes. I mean, the neocons, who really have never accomplished anything except destroy our own country. They've never created a treaty like Jimmy Carter had the Camp David Accord, and Bush Sr., we had the Cambodian Peace Conference. They have accomplished nothing. So Victoria Hewland and her husband and a bunch of the Jewish neocons and others have thought that they could have put Israel in the middle of the map and make it a dominant power. That's not going to happen. Israel has been, will continue to be, a strategic liability for the United States. We will support it to the extent we can, but our major concerns are in East Asia and Southeast Asia, and now India and Pakistan are fighting. So we have much...
Oh, yeah, Kashmir, that's flaring up. Is that a big concern?
That is a major, major concern, because that's two nuclear countries that are really...
Let me ask you this. We need 5 more minutes in the next hour to finish your calls, but let me start asking the question now. Why is it historically that geopolitically everything heats up at once, lines up? Because it's like, I know it's all connected, but it almost just seems like it's a cycle and we just do it. Because all over the world, all hell's breaking loose. Well, why?
Well, I think you hit it on the head. We are interconnected, but we're not interconnected as people thought. We're interconnected because the vacuum of powers cuts right across the world. When we are no longer have an effective leadership like Obama.
And let's face it, the United States has been dominant, and the brain, and when our brain dies, the world dies.
Well, we haven't been effective. I mean, under Condoleezza Rice, we had a disastrous foreign policy. Under Hillary Clinton, we had a disastrous foreign policy. Under Obama, we have done nothing but apologize for things that I don't even understand. You don't go to Laos and say, we're sorry. What you do is you continue to develop your own capabilities, but we don't have a leader who's...
Exactly. They see us as weak, all this ass-kissing. That's 101. Let's come back and talk about that with Dr. Pechenik. Straight ahead, finish a few more calls and hand the baton to David Knight. I'm Alex Jones, InfoWars.com. That's what binds us together, no matter where we're from or what color we are. We love the true diversity of competition. We love free association. We love private property and family and freedom of religion. To not practice it or to practice it, we just believe in freedom. And a bunch of weirdos telling us how to talk and how to live. It's a bunch of spoiled, rotten, crazy academia and media people and social engineers who just are so delusional and never lived in the real world, they think this dog's hunting. All they've done is created a bunch of mental midgets that are their minions, but those are the people that were susceptible to it. They've just created a giant group of people that absolutely hate their guts and are building alternate economies right now. And they hate every other system they can't control, Russia, you name it. It's a very, very dangerous situation. We'll take a few final calls for Dr. Pechenik here and then play the special clip after he leaves and go to David Knight. But going back to Dr. Pechenik, I was asking the question before the break about, you heard the question. Where do you think this is all going?
Well, I think this is going towards a very positive outcome. Number one, it's going to get rid of the Republican Party as it is and should not be. Number two, it's going to focus in on the corruption at the White House on the Clinton Foundation, on the people who are involved with the Clintons, on the Democratic Party. And it's breaking up the entire system in a way that we don't have to go into violence. We don't have to go into chaos. And I find it a very constructive revolution, which is Trump revolution. And I think it's being led by very responsible people.
Which I should add, I've got to admire the people that created the internet in the 60s and 70s, knowing they were giving it to the government as a spy system that would actually be a two-way time bomb, knowing, as I've now researched it deeply, that they knew that the elites would take it for one reason, and it was actually something completely different. And the foresight that, yes, we were going to this decadent cycle, but despite that, putting it into information war would have us be the most advanced country in the world to defeat other corrupt nations, but also defeat our own elite. You talk about some geniuses back then.
Well, let me be very specific. In 1973 at MIT, when I was getting my PhD in political science, one of the things that I was trained by the DARPA, Defense Advanced Research Project Agency, and other intelligence groups in 1973 was the internet and social media.
And by the way, my dad was in that too. It's pretty amazing.
Correct. The internet and social media. So forget Zuckerberg, forget Gates and all that nonsense in Silicon Valley. This was already developed by DARPA. This was already developed by intelligence agencies, and they were using it at that time and understood that it would be a major force in terms of taking down regimes and changing our own regime. They understood that because I was already trained by Ithiel de Solapool, Lucian Pai, and others with respect to regime change. And that was one of the things that we used later on. So the geniuses in America are really incredible. And there are those who speak against us, like Case, and there are those who speak with us, like Paul Thiel. And
well, let me ask this question. How could guys in the 50s, 60s, and 70s envision this whole future world, build it, release it, and it's done so well? I mean, are there still people coming up like that? Because it's amazing.
In some ways, yes, in some way, no. But the basic premise, if you have to remember one thing, is the fact that we had a lot of science fiction writers, Roddenberry, Asimov, all of whom predicted that this would occur. In my own books on the Clancy franchise, I started to write 20 years ago about cyber nations, cyber control, cyber terrorism, and nobody understood that.
Sure, you've been a total visionary in expanding. Talking about Asimov, he predicted in the 40s, not just the whole robot
Correct.
System. He predicted the future, computers predicting the future, which is now here.
Correct. And that's the genius that we do have in the United States. If you leave us alone and let us do what we do best and don't co-opt us with money or with politics, and basically we can do very well and we will continue to do well. We do have that capability. As we
Why is America so special? Because it truly is diverse.
Well, it's not only diverse, but we have really more freedom than anybody realizes. We don't coddle our people, and we allow everybody to come to their fullest potential, despite what is said.
And that's why it's a purposeful, politically correct attack to go after our real diversity and not coddling, and claim that coddling is freedom to create a stagnant system. It's a huge crime.
Well, it is. I mean, I call it the fascism of the left. I mean, when Hillary Clinton says together, together, and she repeats lies and attacks Alex Jones and me and attacks us for Sandy Hook, which we knew was a false flag, and even the fact that 9/11 was an inside job, she's just repeating what Hermann Göring and Goebbels said in Germany, a Nazi. She's nothing more than a spokesperson for the fascist left. And there is an equal amount of fascism on the left.
Sure, both.
Right.
Well, I want to take a few calls and let you go. So you're busy, and I need to go to David Knight. But let me just say this. Clearly, they're going to try to steal the election. I said they'd do it. Now they're federalizing it. Everybody should still vote to be on record to make it a landslide. I think, though, I won't go into all the hundreds of reasons, but just a approximation. If they try to steal it, it's the biggest mistake they ever made. And then that way leads madness. I mean, if they're, and I know there's good people, and I never used to be a person, oh, the government's good, blah, blah, blah. I've just learned statistically people in government are more awake than the general public, on average. And I'm not saying they're great people, but it's like there's innovators on average who are more awake than anybody. But it seems like government's had a front row seat to the corruption, so we shouldn't make it our enemy. They want to create a civil war, the George Soros's. We want to bypass that, but they will try to steal the election. What are your final concerns about that? Because, or do you agree or disagree? Because I just know they're so full of hubris, so full of chutzpah, bravado, that they're going to try it. I mean, we know they are, Donna. What do they have to lose? They're going to do it.
Well, They have everything to lose. They will try to denigrate again Trump, and they will try to denigrate you and me and others involved in it. It will not work. What will happen is basically they're in the process of hurting themselves. They're in a spiral of self-destruction. She was in that spiral from the very beginning when she never disavowed the activities of her husband, who was a total jerk and really was ineffectual. And that spiral of self-destruction will continue. Now she's physically and mentally incapable, so someone has to take over. It won't be Bill Clinton. It'll be Podesta.
Which shows this elite is incompetent, that they would put a corpse forward. I mean, this is the biggest I keep going back to that. This is a total indictment on the Democratic Party and the establishment, and I guess they shouldn't have a crazy old Nazi collaborator at 87 running it.
Well, they put up their choice. It's not an issue anymore of Democrats versus Republicans. It's an issue very much of the American public wants a revolution that's effective, constructive, and lets us to continue to be the predominant power in the world without attacking Iraq, Syria, and
Libya. Oh, can you imagine when Trump cuts taxes by half? Oh, my God.
Well, you know, self-destructiveness is something that we can change by throwing them out, and we can't change their behavior. I mean, you see the nonsensical points that she makes. You see how the entire media is corrupted and co-opted. Remember, the Zuckers who have to run CNN and the other cable companies have lost their audience. You have, as you said before, and I know, a far bigger audience, but we fund these cable companies because of the fees we pay.
I was about to say, I'm not bragging. It's surreal to know that we had 2.5 million viewers last night just on streams, and it's growing. It's surreal to know we had 24,000 phone calls that tried to call in. And I look at CNN's ratings, so I don't get this paradigm, because I still psychologically, you're a psychiatrist, feel like CNN's bigger than me, even though they're not, and I don't understand it. It's kind of like you finally see your dad, he's shorter than you, but he still looks bigger than you. I don't know how to explain that.
Well, what it is the paradox of contention. They think that they can pull all kinds of fast tricks when, in fact, they're hurting themselves. Let me give you an example. The very opening of that whole debate with Franzenkopf, his nonsensical statements, and then bringing out a Singaporean student to talk about democracy was absurd. Singapore, under Lee Kuan Yew, whom I knew and I worked with, is the most repressive society in Asia. It is effective, but it is a demagoguery. And to put him there as a symbol of democracy was an absurd statement on behalf of the University of Washington and the man who ran the so-called Presidential Commission. They had no idea what they were doing. It shows you how...
Isn't Singapore a British totalitarian test?
Well, it was, but Singapore left, and Lee Kuan Yew, who was studied at Oxford, got a PhD, initially became a communist, made it into a highly repressive...
No, I know. They, like, call him the dean of the island and everything, and it's
correct.
Just...
Correct. I mean, he is a highly honorable individual, but he is total repression. So to put a Singaporean student there to represent democracy is an oxymoron.
I was about to say, but that's the problem. As soon as he goes, he's an honorable guy, runs a technocracy... And so, yeah, low crime overall, but it's a total tyranny, but a good tyranny in that it was run by a good guy. As soon as he leaves, it degenerates.
That's correct, but it shows you the stupidity of the Presidential Commission, the fact that neither one of the examiners, Anderson Cooper, questioned it. It showed you that Franzenkopf had no idea of what he was doing, and it showed you the University of Washington had no idea of what they were doing. So once again, ignorance is prevalent in our academia, in our media, and in our candidates. And Trump is learning, and he's a fast learner. And the minute he picks that up, he hits them. And that's what people can't tolerate. Also, they envy him because he was able to achieve a wealth at the risk of his own well-being. I mean, you don't get to build billions of dollars of net worth on the basis of somebody giving you millions. You can still throw that away. That's not even relevant. He never gave up. And you can see he keeps on going on flight after flight after flight to town after town, whereas Hillary can't do anything. She's totally incapacitated.
And it shows how the media goes along with it, and they wonder why their ratings drop and drop. They don't. It's just like... It's watching lemmings go off the edge of a cliff. Let's take a few calls and let Pechenik go, because I got to go to David here. We're skipping this break. Mike in Louisiana, you're on the air worldwide with Dr. Steve Pachinik.
Yeah, listen, I don't know if you caught this, but last night when Trump was saying that Hillary and Obama won't say anything about radical Islamic terrorists, when she was during her response, she called it radical jihadist terror. And then right after that, she said it has nothing to do with Islam.
I know, I saw that. Meanwhile, they're saying it's bad that he tweeted she is a criminal, saying she is now sexist to say someone's a woman. This is total assault on language. Dr. Pachinik, what is this attack on language? I mean, obviously, it's to create total mental illness.
It's a distraction, but basically it's the beginning of trying to create thought control. You know, George Orwell warned us of it. It's
sure, reducing language then.
I'm sorry?
So it's 1984. It's reducing language.
Yeah, it's reducing language to basically the ability for them to control what we say and how we say it. It's nonsensical. It's not even relevant. It's academic foolishness. Language.
I agree. So it shows how delusional they are that this would actually work.
Oh, absolutely. But it gives a lot of academicians, salaries, and it gives the president something to say or do other than the fact he's wasting our money and time.
Sure, but how do you sit around a boardroom and go, let's attack language and reduce it down to nothing so we destroy civilization? I mean, these people are reprobate.
Well, they don't know the history of World War II. What it shows is the complete ignorance of Hillary Clinton, Bill Clinton, Obama, and the neocons in terms of what happened during World War II. They claim they understand it. These neocon Jews are as stupid as they come. And unfortunately, they came from my university, Cornell, which produced Steve Hadley, Paul Wolfowitz, Sandy Berger, and Fukuyama. All morons. Academic
Well, I think
morons.
The main prime mover, whether, you know, they be neocons or whatever they are, is they are arrogant. These people, like, float around in this self-delusion. And
well,
like,
they have no jobs. They're not able to do what you or I or the ordinary American is able to do, to go out, make a living on their own, and create an asset. They've never created an asset. All they can do is become sycophants in Washington, D.C., get a pension from some think tank, the Rand Corporation, the Brookings Institute, which is a joke, run by Strobe Talbot, the man who cleaned up Bill Clinton. He was his cleaner and a CIA operative. I mean, these are not very bright people.
That's right. You show that Talbot was the handler of Hillary and Bill, I guess, in England.
Exactly. He was the one who said, oh, no, Myrna was not a problem. Bill Clinton was not a problem. He's totally complicit. All collusive agents. And I know.
Well, I read, tell me this is accurate, that when they sent the Clintons into Russia, they were like some of the worst agents ever.
Well, Bill Clinton never showed up at Oxford. He was on a Fulbright scholarship. He went in and he was supposed to monitor anti-war protesters, and he was totally a disaster. But the agency doesn't really care whether you're effective. What they care about is that you have the profile like Bill Clinton. No father. Mother was a prostitute, and you had a father figure. Same thing with Obama. No father or father Kenya. But the real issue is his mother that they never talk about. She's a CIA operative. Maternal grandmother CIA, maternal grandfather CIA. He's a product of the CIA, a mulatto mixture who was brought out with no accomplishment, no future, and no capability to do anything. So what they were interested was control. They didn't really, the CIA has no capability to think strategically or act strategically. They've co-opted.
They just further their own aims.
Well, you got John Brennan, you got Doolin, you've got, you know, all kinds of pathetic individuals who really were ineffectual in intelligence. Eisenhower said it. A whole bunch of our generals have said it. I've said it repeatedly. I oversaw them in terms of military intelligence. They were pathetic. Yet they co-opted our military to do SOCOM, to do
SOCOM. I know. I can't believe they're taking over the military. Angie in Alaska, you're on the air with Dr. Steve Pachinik. Go ahead.
Yes, Dr. Pachinik, I agree with you that the American people, we do want a revolution. We want a revolution against our crony government. We want a revolution against them putting us into wars that we don't want. We want to revolt and have jobs instead of them making us lose our jobs with the EPA and all their bureaucratic BS.
Sure.
And I really think that last night's debate was fantastic. I think that for anybody who's ever been a victim of sexual violence, I think that Donald Trump probably stood up for more women last night than I've ever seen anybody.
Well, let me tell you, I've never endorsed a candidate like this and gotten behind him. And before I did, because I don't like the casinos and stuff, I really did some snooping. I made some phone calls. I did some stuff. And if Trump does anything, he spoils the daylights out of women. So he's a rapist like I'm an Easter bunny.
Yeah, I thought it was phenomenal that he stood up for those women. And if anybody's even seen the videos, it's deplorable what the Clintons have done to these women. And I just, our senators up here, they're like, this weekend they were saying, oh, they're not going to support Donald Trump. He needs to stand down. And that,
yeah, doesn't that go to the arrogance? Bill Clinton is settling rape cases. Hillary covers up. She represents pedophiles. And they're bitching at him about some secret edited racy tape put out by a Bush, and Jerry Falwell Jr.'s come out and said he thinks the Republicans leaked it. Of course him leaving the show is fake. Of course Bush did this. Of course it's edited. You can hear the damn tape. Now, you can tell Trump's advisors said, listen, they'll never believe it's edited. Just say you're sorry. The damn thing is edited. They're asking him questions. Dr. Pechenik.
I think what you said, madam, is correct. And I think what you need to do and your colleagues and your state is to put your representatives on notice to explain to you and to everybody else what in fact are they accomplishing, what in fact have they done other than go to meetings and talk a lot. I find, and I've treated many congressmen and senators, I find they do nothing. I find that they spend years just talking about themselves.
They're not visionaries. The elite hire a bunch of yes men. We need visionaries again.
Well, I'm not sure we even need congressional representatives and senators, because I think what this person, you've pointed out very clearly, all they really do is basically talk and talk down somebody. But as a constituent, I want to know what my representative does. And I'm not very impressed on either side. But I am impressed that it cost us a lot of money.
Well said, Dr. Pechenik. Folks really love you on the show. It's crazy. You've been on 15 years.
I love to be on your show, and I admire what you've done. I know, Alex, you don't like it, but you have been in the forefront, and that is important, Alex.
Well, I can't help it.
We could not have done this. I'm being very frank. You know, when I had Steve Quayle and then you guys, I mean, it's been a huge effort on behalf of a lot of people, but you've kept on going. And whatever vitamins you're taking, please keep on doing it.
God bless you, brother. We'll talk to you soon. We appreciate your work.
Take care and bless the audience.
Thank you. All right, I'm out of time. I got callers in Canada, everything. I got to go. I got meetings, and I got a sick family member. I got to go deal with it. So a lot going on. I'm going to go out to break with this clip. This is something they put together. We're going to go put this out as a viral video with just a shorter GIF of it. But this is Clinton with the creepy eyes, but in slow motion, it's even worse. With Trump in slow motion talking to him, it's epic. Let's start rolling it.
But Bill Clinton was abusive to women. Hillary Clinton attacked those same women and attacked them viciously. Four of them here tonight. One of the women, who is a wonderful woman, at 12 years old, was raped at 12. Her client, she represented, got him off, and she's seen laughing on two separate occasions, laughing at the girl who was raped. Kathy Shelton, that young woman, is here with us tonight. So don't tell me about words. I apologize for those words. But it is things that people say. But what President Clinton did, he was impeached. He lost his license to practice law. He had to pay an $850,000 fine to one of the women, Paula Jones, who's also here tonight. And I will tell you that when Hillary brings up a point like that, and she talks about words that I said 11 years ago, I think it's disgraceful, and I think she should be ashamed of herself, if you want to know the truth.
Her client, she represented, got him off, and she's seen laughing on two separate occasions, laughing at the girl who was raped. But what President Clinton did, he was impeached, he lost his license to practice law, he had to pay an $850,000 fine to one of the women, Paula Jones, who's also here tonight, and I will tell you that when Hillary brings up a point like that, and she talks about words that I said 11 years ago.
And again, we have it slowed down too, where he turns his eyes and looks. That's what I come back with. That was the clip I wanted. But that is important to see. It's important to understand that. It's important to really just slow that down and see Bill Clinton in the crosshairs there, because nobody ever stands up against these people. And we are doing it. Infowars.com. I'm going to come back and introduce David Knight and get out of here. But this is a very big time to be alive. One of my own today, I'm on Selenium, Supermel Vitality, and X2 that I put in my water this morning. That supports the broadcast. You really want these nutraceuticals. You owe it to yourself to have these supplements. InfoWarsLife.com. It's a win-win. It funds the operation, and they are really good. All right, I'm going to hand the baton to David Knight. I appreciate the great job he did last night. The crew got an A+. I'd give them a 97 last night. I got a B+. Went a little wild during the broadcast. Should have told them to fade audio down. I was screaming over Hillary. But here's the difference. I did 6 hours. I'm the guy in the arena stumbling around with a bunch of arrows sticking out of me. So it's okay. But the crew is amazing. They did a great job. I'll hand the baton to David Knight. Here's the bottom line. The hoax, the big Trump didn't say, I'm Mr. Goody Two-Shoes. Oh, my God. He said, I want to fight the globalists. I want better trade deals. I want to cut taxes. We know the old crime families there. I'm not going to defend Trump if he goes sideways when he gets in office. But they're going to be after him day one. But buying into some hoax and it's all over, some edited tape the Bush has put out, even Jerry Falwell Jr. sees through it. That's up on InfoWars.com. We got new WikiLeaks. I'm talking about dead bodies and buried bodies. I mean, this is, thank God WikiLeaks is putting this out. Just see through it. Now, if Hillary's in prison and they're all in trouble and stuff's better, we got a better candidate and Trump's doing bad stuff. Okay, Trump, you're in trouble. But, I mean, it's a joke. Can you imagine if Trump had represented a child rapist and knew the person was guilty and they put a 12-year-old girl in a coma? What they do to him, or if he was on Epstein's plane. I mean, it's ridiculous, the hypocrisy. And thank goodness that's all blowing away. The third time they say he's going to resign, step down, all the Republicans are against him. Don't let these Republicans creep back and support him again. You guys, everybody that came out against Trump is public enemy number one, should have recalls and should be removed. You pieces of trash. David Knight from the radio studio takes over. 9 News Tonight, 7 o'clock Central. Lord willing, I'll be back tomorrow, 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. before the next host takes over. If you're watching this transmission, history just happened. Trump took the gloves off and won big time. Despite the fact it was 3-1. David Knight.
Thank you, Alex. You know, I was just looking at this article from Geraldo Rivero saying, I've got tapes of embarrassing statements from Donald Trump. Putting this out here, and I want to remind you of where Geraldo Rivero is coming from. You know, this guy is someone
who's just recently... Al Capone's vault.
Yeah. He found him in Al Capone's vault, yeah. That was his famous episode before. But one of the things that he's gotten a lot of flack for recently, and maybe he's trying to inoculate himself from criticism because he supported Roger Ailes. And he came out and he said, well, after he supported Roger Ailes, and after Roger Ailes left, he said, I want to apologize for having supported him. And Juanita Broderick said... Too little, too late. The same thing you did to the women Ailes abused is what you continue to do to the women that Bill Clinton abused, Geraldo Rivero. She said, not long ago, when my name was brought up during a Fox panel discussion, you said it made you, quote, throw up in your mouth to hear the name Juanita Broderick. That was the reaction that Geraldo Rivero had. She said, shame on you, Geraldo Rivero. You're disgusting. Apology not accepted. And now he's... throwing out the idea, hey, I've got some stuff that I want to dump on Trump. Okay? What is his mission here? Is Geraldo trying to, again, inoculate himself? Has he got an agenda that he wants to purify America's speech? Does he want to make the White House pure, clean up the media, clean up television, clean up film? No. He opposes Donald Trump on policy. But this is the method he chooses to attack him. Just as the Bushes used that method to attack him. And now Billy Bush has been suspended by NBC. Why? Because NBC was going to release this stuff. Billy Bush couldn't wait. He was working with the Clintons. And when all of this stuff that we're going to talk about here in just a couple of moments here that came out with Podesta's emails, very damaging stuff, they had to come up with something to distract you. They needed a red herring. Remember that? A red herring. When the Fox hounds were on the trail of the Fox, they would have the people that didn't like fox hunting in England come out with stinky fish, with red herrings, and run them over the trail of the fox when he runs by to throw the hounds off of the scent. And that's precisely what Billy Bush did for Hillary Clinton. They all work together, folks. I thought it was pretty amazing to see how the media was coming out against Donald Trump yesterday. You look at the way Politico spun it yesterday. This is... the conventional wisdom of the pundits yesterday before the debate. This was yesterday afternoon. Politico, Glenn Thrush says, you know, Trump isn't merely facing an uphill battle last night. He said, or the widespread perception he's not up to the job, or even that he's too unlikable to get elected. No, he's having to grapple with all of these problems at once, while cloaked in disgrace, coping with an unprecedented defection of more than 24 Republican former supporters who feel that endorsing him has become a moral transgression. Making a big issue out of nothing. That was what the red herring was about, folks. They were trying to throw this away. You understand, this is about the policy issues. They try to make it about something else. They try to make it about something that they do all the time. The very people who give us this potty mouth culture, this over-sexualized culture, the very websites that have softcore porn or hardcore porn all over the website, they have a problem with what he had to say. Yeah, it's the society we live in. Unfortunately, it's the society we live in. But what hypocrisy for these people. As I said last night, it's like Matt Damian, who makes all of his money doing films about Bourne, Jason Bourne and guns, coming out to try to shut down guns. But Trump really was the man in the arena. He rose to the occasion last night. But even after that, we see Bob Schieffer, the former Face the Nation host, saying, I am disgusted with this. This was disgraceful what happened last night when Donald Trump won. When Donald Trump did the unprecedented and brought out these women who were victims of Bill Clinton to emphasize the fact that we're not talking about consensual sex with Bill Clinton. It was never about that. The media made it about that 20 some odd years ago. They made it about Monica Lewinsky. They made it about Jennifer Flowers. They didn't want to talk about Juanita Broderick and those issues. They didn't want to talk about the rape. They wanted to say, well, he's having an affair. And guess what? All the people who were shaking their heads and going tisk, tisk, tisk about what Donald Trump said, and I'm not defending his comments about trying to commit adultery, but these same people saw it as a badge of honor for Bill Clinton. He became even more popular with the very Democrats who are now criticizing Donald Trump. But here's what Bob Schieffer said last night, because he was so distraught about the fact that Donald Trump turned this around, went on the offensive, and made some great points. So Bob Schieffer says, this is disgraceful. He says, here we're marching in women into the hall who are supposed to have some relationship with one of the candidate's spouses. What's that supposed to prove? Well, it proves that Hillary Clinton has, from the very beginning of her career, thrown women under the bus for her career. Just as she did that 12-year-old girl, threw her under the bus, laughed about how she got this rapist of a 12-year-old girl off the hook on a technicality. And she has done that for Bill Clinton time and again and again and again. And so Donald Trump brought those women in to remind people this is not about consensual sex. This is about rape. And it is about the woman who covers for the rapist. The woman who throws the women under the bus and says, vote for me because I'm a woman. I'm all about women. Yeah, right. But he says, listen to what he had to say. They're supposed to have had some relationship. See how Bob Schieffer spins that? They're still selling that. These women are supposed to have had some relationship with the spouse of a candidate. What a liar. What a, you know, Bob Schieffer, you are a disgrace. You and CBS and NBC and the rest of these people who have their hidden agenda, who are rigging this, you're a bunch of liars, crooks, and thieves. Absolutely amazing what they did. Donald Trump nailed Hillary Clinton last night. She came out and she said, well, I'm not happy with Citizens United, that Supreme Court decision that says political speech is free speech. You may not like it that people with a lot of money jump into this thing, but that truly is free speech. I know one of the people who was involved in Citizens United, and it wasn't simply about big money. Understand, the big guys know how to navigate the rules. They know how to navigate the FEC. They know how to give millions of dollars to the candidate that they want to give money to. No question about that. It's the small guys that get trapped, like Dinesh D'Souza, who didn't understand the rules. Dinesh D'Souza could have easily given $25,000 to his college friend if he had gone through a super PAC. He could have created a super PAC, filed the paperwork with the FEC and so forth and so on. These other people are giving millions of dollars to these candidates and get away with it. Don't have a problem with it. See, the rich people will always find a way, covertly, criminally, or whatever they need to do, but they'll invent a legal structure that nobody else can do to give this money. So what Citizens United did was it was about some people in Montana who were being shut down, not able to exercise their freedom of speech. It was a citizen advocacy group. And I know one of the people that was involved in that. And I agree with what was done with that. Now, people look at this and say, well, it's freed up big money from corporations. And I think, you don't understand. The corporations are free to put their money through as they wish. They will find a way to get that through. The laws are for the little gnats. The big bees will go through those spider webs with no problem whatsoever. And so that's really what Citizens United was about. But, okay, you want to complain about Citizens United, Hillary? Donald Trump challenged Hillary Clinton to spend her own money, this is Washington Times, on her presidential campaign on Sunday, saying it would give her some independence from her donors. Clinton had blasted the Citizens United court decision that opened the door to groups spending unlimited money to get a message out on elections. She said she would appoint Supreme Court justices who would overturn that ruling. And so Donald Trump called her on her bluff. He says, hey, you don't have to wait for that. You can spend your own money. You don't have to be beholden to Wall Street. You know, you don't have to give those $250,000 speeches and do them over and over again. You don't have to make $22 million talking to bankers on Wall Street. You know, you can use your own money. You've made a lot of money with those speeches, so you don't have to rely on Citizens United. Go ahead and do it, Hillary. He called her bluff. He came out and he said, well, I'm going to spend up to $100 million on my own money on the campaign. So he challenged her to spend $30 million. Why don't you spend $30 million, Hillary, out of the $250 million you and your husband have gotten from Wall Street speeches? He says, why don't you put some money in? Guess what? Hillary didn't say anything. That was a key thing last night. You know, when Donald Trump finally turned, he got tired of people attacking him again and again and again on the stuff that was released by the Bushes for the Clintons. He got tired of it. You know, first they came up with a questionnaire. That was enough. So then Anderson Cooper comes out. Then Hillary Clinton comes. And then they hit him again. And it's like, okay, you know what? All right, let's tell you what this is really about. And then at that point, he took over the debate. And he was in control. And when he called Hillary Clinton out on what she had done with the emails, she had absolutely nothing to say. She had this stammering, repetitive statement about, well, fact checking. Go to my website and you'll see what the facts are. Read my version of the facts. I fact check all this stuff about the emails. We know what's going on with the emails, Hillary. We don't need to go see your spin on your website. We know precisely what's there. She finished up by saying, and I don't like the character of somebody like Donald Trump. Boy, sure, good thing that we don't have Donald Trump as somebody with his character as president. He says, yeah, because you'd be in jail. Oh, he and it didn't get any better for her the rest of the time through. Now, when we look at these emails, and I think this is the real story. This is why they came out with this garbage from the Bushes, from Billy Bush. They didn't want you to see what Hillary Clinton was talking about. One of the things that has bothered me since the 90s was how she got away with Cattlegate. And as I said yesterday on the broadcast, it was a classic sting moment. Remember the sting with Robert Redford and Paul Newman? The way they got the guy that they were taking down was to set up this elaborate hoax where they go to a place where there's a horse race that's being broadcast. And it's a real horse race, but they delay it a little while. So they know how to lay the bets off, and they trick this guy because they know they got like a 5 to 10 minute delay on who the winner was. And that's how they take this guy down. That's what Hillary Clinton did with Cattlegate. You got to understand that. So she goes to a bunch of Wall Street hedge fund managers and she says, you know, it's always been a little bit risky for me to come and speak to a group that's committed to the futures market because, and there's a few knowing laughs, she says. She acknowledges, hi, you guys are chuckling. Yeah, you know what? I pulled over on those schmucks, the voters, the American public. She says, many years ago, I actually traded in the futures market. I worked with a group of like-minded friends and associates who traded in pork bellies and cotton and other such things, and I did pretty well. I invested about $1,000, and I traded up to about $100,000. She did that in a very short period of time, and then she was done because that's the way Hillary Clinton laundered her money in the 1990s. Now, she's got a squeaky clean little tax return that's been prepared for her by the law firm that Comey and Loretta Lynch used to work for. They used to do her taxes, you realize, okay? That's why they're not going to prosecute her. These people are her minions from way back. But she has these squeaky, clean little tax returns. But she does things like Cattlegate. She does things like the Clinton Foundation. That's where the big money is. That's where she rolls this stuff out. Okay. Now, the biggest thing, and we keep coming back to this, I think, is her dream. Her dream that she told the bankers. My dream, she said. And of course, her dream, folks, is your nightmare. A hemispheric common market with open borders and a future with energy that's green as sustainable as we can get it, and we all get rich. No, she will get rich. You will be locked into the cities, into an Agenda 21 existence. That is the dream they have, taking down our countries, creating, and that's what the NAFTA trade agreement was about. That's what the European Union is about. It's about creating a political, they create the euro, they create the NAFTA trade agreement. They do this economically. They create an economic union. That's what they're doing now with the transatlantic, transpacific partnerships. They're creating economic structures that will then be used to create economic disaster, to put political pressure on. As we saw the problems with the euro, we heard all last year, the only way we're going to solve this is with greater political consolidation. And of course, there's been a couple of things that have come out over the weekend, and we can see how this Agenda 21, UN agenda is going to be put on us. Understand, these folks have for the longest time had a goal of between, and the years have always been 2020, 2025, or 2030. They're always talking about that's when everything is going to happen. What is the future going to look like for you? I'm going to tell you when we come back what that's going to look like. We've got European governments right now saying they're going to ban all internal combustion engines. They're going to ban drivers from the roads. They're going to take control of our transportation. We'll be right back. Stay with us. Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight. I'm going to give you a picture of the future. Hillary Clinton's dream, your nightmare, being locked into the cities, into your little 200-square-foot padded cell. And I'm going to tell you how they're going to do that in just a moment. Before I do, real quickly, I want to remind you that we have ending soon our sale on DNA Force, 23% off at InfoWarsLife.com. And, of course, this is the supplement that is loaded with patented BioPQQ. It's backed by 175 clinical studies, extremely hard to secure, very expensive to produce. This one ingredient costs about $30,000 per batch. And so this is a premium product. When you get this at 23% off, that is a big savings. It is one of our best supplements and one of our most difficult and expensive to produce. So take advantage of that savings, 23% off at InfoWarsLife.com. Also, our InfoWars solar base power station supply, now 33% off retail at InfoWarsStore.com. And we talk about power supplies, solar power supplies. I think it's a great idea to have your own power supply, to be off the grid, to be independent. But understand that when we're talking about banning the internal combustion engine, about shutting down driving, that is not about getting independence. That's the exact opposite. That is about subjecting you to a control grid. That is how they're going to implement Agenda 21. You look at Agenda 21, you look at the UN Agenda for Sustainable Development, the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development, and you say, yeah, nobody's going to want to be confined to the cities like this. You know, the cars freed us from the cities. Most people don't want to live in crowded, expensive, disease-ridden cities. Thomas Jefferson said, cities are a threat to the health, the wealth, and the liberty of man, and it's never been more true than it is today. So cars gave us the opportunity to get to the suburbs, and the central planners, the people who run the cities, have hated them ever since. They've done everything to make it difficult. But now look at what they're doing. We've had in Europe, we had first back in April, we had Norway and Sweden say that they were going to ban internal combustion engines by 2025. And at the time they did that, everybody said, well, France and Germany are going to have something to say about that. They're not going to do something that radical, ban internal combustion engines within 9 years. Well, over the weekend, we had the German parliamentary procedure come out and say that they want to ban internal combustion engines by 2030. And they want to push the EU to do this. Germany is the EU, folks. You have to understand that. They have taken over that government. That is, they have done with the European Union what Hitler could not do, what Kaiser Wilhelm could not do. They're going to ban internal combustion engines in Europe. What are they doing in the United States? You think they're going to do it here? Of course they will. And of course, when they ban them in Europe, it's going to put pressure on global car manufacturers to go to electric cars or whatever with limited range, with all the problems that are involved in that. That's what the war against Volkswagen, against the clean diesel fuel is all about. But now look at this new front here. We have on Road and Track magazine this weekend, they said feds set a goal of zero U.S. traffic deaths within 30 years. Let me tell you something. Whenever you see some kind of utopian pronouncements from a government, you got to know that there's going to be authoritarian mandates coming down the road. How are they going to enforce this? We've got five different federal agencies, from the U.S. Department of Transportation all the way down. Everybody that touches cars and trucks, all of these agencies are working on this goal. They've even got a name for it. The Road to Zero. The Road to Zero. Boy, does that say it all. They're going to lock you in your 200-square-foot padded cell inside the cities where you'll be safe as long as you don't have a bathtub or something else that can kill you. This is the insanity. This is what they're doing, and this is the way they're going to do it. They're going to control the guns. They're going to control your transportation. They're going to surveil you everywhere you go. They're going to make cars part of the Internet of Things. Join us tonight for the InfoWars Nightly News, 7 Central, 8 p.m. Eastern.